scheduled to have preliminaries or heats in the morning local time and in the evenings swim finals local time. And indeed, it is approaching 5:30 in Rio de Janeiro. And the final session of day six is practically upon us. It's a final session that has a great deal of excitement to look forward to, including the race between Bogodajko and indeed Rudy Garcia Tolson of the United States. They've won the gold medal between them the last three Paralympic Games in the SM Servant 200 IM. The 100 freestyle men's S10 should see Andre Brazilian Felipe Rodriguez up against Dubrovnik Kripak of Ukraine. Rivard and Pasco go head to head in the women's 100 meter S10 freestyle, while in the 100 back S8. World record holder Stephanie Millwood looking good for gold, but she's up against Slater, Elliott, Patterson, Long, and indeed Lizzie Marks. While in the women's 50 free, Michelle Conkeley looking to back up their gold medal and world record she swam on day five of competition. She'll face Australia's Ellie Cole and, of course, Sarai Gascon of Spain, another contender in that event. There's plenty of action to look forward to as China continue to dominate the medal standings. Ukraine have been looking good in the medal standings as well. But there's one athlete who'll be in action tonight who stands head and shoulders above. Sophie Pascoe of New Zealand is looking to do something exceptional. She's looking to claim Paralympic gold medals in four consecutive days. She started with a silver medal in the women's 50 freestyle. And then she's just gone from strength to strength in an incredible run of days. Gold in the 100 back, 200 IM gold, and then the 100 fly title. The last two she defended from London, and indeed the 100 back she won back after claiming gold 8 years ago in Beijing. An opportunity to claim four in a row, but she's up against the world record holder in Aurelie Rivard. Of course, there are several parents, family members and supporters of various delegations and swimming teams. Team Turner supporting Nicole Turner, just 14 years old, is swimming in yet another final at the Paralympic Games. Australia and New Zealand are always well supported. New Zealand certainly punching above their weight when it comes to the swimming competition. Ukraine and China lead the way. Korea Republic, Great Britain, they've all been doing exceptionally well. And Australia looking for further medals in the pool. But lest we forget the Brazilian support and the Brazilian swimmers who've done so very well, led by the brilliance of Daniel Dias. Not in action today, although Andre Brazil goes in the men's S10 100 free.
Yes, and the Brazilian crowd will have plenty to get excited about in the first final of the evening as well, with Talisson Glock from Brazil swimming in the men's 400 metres S6 final.
This is where we start, the men's 400 freestyle S6 final. Talisson Glock will be going in lane two. For the home fans, now this is how they line up. Harnappel, Glock, Luhr, Van Hoffwegen, Bucciardi, Perez, McLean and Yang. Swimmers from 1 to 8. The world record still held by Anders Olsen, going back now some 7 years, while his Paralympic record still stands from Beijing. Swimmers will be introduced individually come the finals. No different on day six. Swimming in lane eight, 16-year-old Yang Hong, bronze in the 100 breaststroke at his first games. And competing in para swimming against his hero, Xu Qing. Not in this race, same pool. Matthew Harnappel of Australia goes in lane one after a 5:36.09 in the preliminaries. 16-year-old Hamish McLean. At the World Championships last year, he was the youngest para swimmer for New Zealand in Glasgow. He missed out on medals in the 200 IM in the 50 free finals. He was eighth in the 2015 World Championships, though. Talisson Glock of Brazil, his penultimate individual event. Bronze in the 200 IM and 4x50 mixed relay. Silver for Talisson Glock already at Rio 2016. Going in lane six, Lorenzo Perez Escalona of Cuba, 30-year-old, fourth in the 53. He'll need an improvement on that to finish in the medals in the 400 free. There is Perez Escalona. Luo Jinbiao of China, his first of two events in Rio. 22-year-old goes in lane three after a very promising 5:20.77 in the qualifying. For Italy, Francesco Bucciardi, the 22-year-old from Genoa, is the reigning world champion. A qualifying time of 5:18.61. And then the man who posted the quickest time in the preliminaries, the morning heats, Thijs van Hofwegen, the 19-year-old from Amersfoort in the Netherlands, eighth in the 53, seventh in the 100 back, looking for his first medal in arguably his strongest event. Van Hofwegen goes in lane four. McLean of New Zealand swam a 5:38 to finish eighth in the World Championships last year. He's going substantially faster already. Would need to lob about 4 seconds off his personal best, which is about a second every 100 meters. It's doable. But a 16-year-old with limited experience on the international stage, Hamish McLean. Van Hofwegen, the swimmer to look out for, going in lane four, up against the world champion Bucciardi of Italy, going in lane five. Luo in three, dangerous, and indeed Perez of Cuba in lane six. So they line up: Harnappel, Glock, Luo, Van Hofwegen, Bucciardi, Perez, McLean, and Yang. Glock with a crowd behind him, looking for his third medal of Rio 2016. Get underway very, very quickly, especially in lane six. Perez got off to a storming start, while Van Hofwegen, who likes to lead out frantically and rather furiously, got off to a slow start. But once he's in the water, he is going very strongly. Matthew Harnappel of Australia going in lane one, threatened to pull away in the opening 25, but already is being caught by the swimmers around him. McLean being left behind, the New Zealand swimmer going in lane seven. But it's not about where you touch at the opening 50, it's about touching at the 400. This race, eight lengths of this Olympic pool, is about pacing yourself, finding a rhythm, getting your tempo right throughout the stroke, and finding a comfortable stroke. And Van Hofwegen and Perez seem to have settled, and they are currently leading, with Bucciardi, the world champion, biding his time and just within striking distance, not allowing the swimmers to get more than a body length ahead of him.
Yes, that first 50 was a 32.99 from Perez, the 30-year-old, showing his experience, though, not taking it out too hard. Now the three, Perez, Bocciardi and Van Hofwegen, now almost neck and neck as they come through to the first 100 split.
So at the split, it is Van Hofwegen who leads by less than 3/10 of a second from Perez, and Bocciardi now starting to make a move. So Bocciardi is taking on Van Hofwegen, and just a little message to the youngster: I've got the strength, I've got the endurance, and I've also got the speed. Have you? Can you come with me? Perez will be watching Bucciardi, currently on his inside. We'll know that he's capable of meddling, Perez, but he would want to get as high up the medal placings as he possibly can. Now almost neck and neck with Van Hofwegen, but it is Bucciardi who touches 2 seconds in front at the 150 split.
Well, Luo Jinbiao as well is just staying in touch with the medals. He's swimming in fourth place at the moment, but he has made up a little bit of ground on Perez. Perez dropping off, and he'll be well off the gold medal pace at least coming into the 200 split. So Van Hofwegen and Bocciardi really untouchable at the moment. opening up 2 to 3 body lengths on the rest of the field as he comes through to the 200 split.
Certainly not on world record pace at the moment, Bucciardi, but he turns in 2:25.33, and he's leading by a very comfortable margin now, 4.5 seconds virtually. Perez touches third quickest and is still very close on the shoulder of Van Hoffwegen, but it was the turn that changed it for Van Hoffwegen. He had a superb turn. Perez lost some serious time in the water. Luhr just looks like he's dropping back a little. 2:37.13, and Luhr, after swimming 39s in consecutive 50-meter splits, has just posted a 42, which might suggest his race is over, bar a splendid comeback. Perez, though, is slowing considerably as well, and a very poor turn let him down at the 200 mark. At the 250, it is Bucciardi ahead of Van Hoffwegen, and Perez still holding on for third.
Perez certainly tired, and coming into the 250, he'll be hoping to stay easily in bronze position, but don't forget the Chinese athlete, Yu Jinbiao, is staying in touch there. He's hanging tough, and Taliesin Glock, we can expect a big cheer from the crowd because he's not out of medal contention entirely.
Well, Glock has a fairly strong finish as well, and he's a bit of a sprinter. He's got some endurance, but he's got the endurance of an individual medley swimmer, but he's also got the speed of a sprinter, Taliesin Glock, and he's got a very powerful kick. And he, at the moment, is looking to just shape into medal contention with a swim that sees him go beyond Luhr in this leg. But first at the turn, at 300, it's Bucciardi ahead of Van Hoffwegen, with Perez still holding on to that third place. Glock touches now fourth ahead of Luhr. And it looks like Hamish McLean of New Zealand is going to touch for seventh after Harnapple touched in 4:04.49 at the 300. Yang Hong of People's Republic of China is swimming in the outside lane in lane 8. But at the moment, Glock is mounting a challenge, and he's getting the Brazilian support as well. He's pulling away from Luhr. At the 350 split, it's Bucciardi who touches first. It is Van Hoffwegen who touches second. And Perez is coming in for third, but Glock is chasing him down.
Glock really made his move between the 3 and 350 mark, and you can hear the crowd wheeling him on into that bronze medal position. He's not far off the pace of Perez at the moment. Perez looking very tired.
Perez will be very aware of it. He knows that he's tiring. He knows that he's dropping back and has suddenly gone from 39s to 42s. Bucciardi, though, is the focus of the attention right now for a few. Although Glock is the focus of the attention for this partisan crowd, Perez holding on, Bucciardi will take the gold. He'll be outside a personal best and well outside the 5-minute mark. Van Hoffwegen of the Netherlands comes in to claim his first Paralympic Games medal, while Perez is just going to hold on ahead of a fast-closing Glock. Perez takes third, the bronze medal to Cuba. Glock gets applauded for his fourth-placed effort. Luhr of China will finish fifth. But the Italians are celebrating another gold medal in the pool. And this time it's gone the way of Bucciardi. Harnapple touches for sixth. McLean touches for seventh for New Zealand. And Yang Hong of People's Republic of China home in a 5:33.71. Francesco Bucciardi, the world champion, would not be denied. A little fist pump for the Italian. Van Hoffwegen, oh, he is completely spent. He is completely spent. A 5:07.82 for Van Hoffwegen, a personal best, and Perez had to swim in America's record to keep Glock at bay. Just great on the turn was Bucciardi. Certainly made it count. While he missed out on making the finals in the 53, only finished fifth in his heat. The 400 free was always going to be his event at his second Paralympic Games. But at his first, in his first final, and applause for the champion. Italy have another gold medal in the pool. Bucciardi ahead of Van Hoffwegen. Perez Escalona claiming the bronze. Taliesin Glock misses out. China with two representatives, and Australia and New Zealand miss out on medals. This is the final of the women's 400 meter freestyle S6. Trejo, Savtsova, Simmonds, Mereshko, Song, Robinson, Turner, and Romano go in this final, representing Mexico, Ukraine, Great Britain, Ukraine, China, Great Britain, Ireland, and Italy, respectively. Now this is a race that comes down to Mereshko versus Simmonds, you would imagine. They go in lanes 3 and 4. Song Lingling might have something to say about that, but to introduce the finalist, Emanuele Romano, might be spurred on by Italian success already in the pool on day 6 of competition. She goes in lane 8, the former 53 world champion. From Mexico, Vianney Trejo Delgadillo goes in lane 1. Going in lane 7, 14-year-old Nicole Turner. Swam in the finals of 6 events that she entered at the 2015 World Championships. This is her 4th finals in Rio. No medals in either World Championships or Paralympic Games, but invaluable experience. Victoria Savtsova, silver in the 53 and the 100 breasts, and bronze in the 4x50 mixed relay. She's very quick in the water over the shorter distances, but is an outside bet at a medal in the 400 free. Going in lane 6, the 15-year-old gold medalist in the 100 fly, focused on the job at hand, the task at hand of Great Britain, Ellie Robinson. Just delighted to be swimming with her hero, who will go in lane 3, gold medalist in 2008, gold medalist in 2012, Eleanor Simmonds, Ellie Simmonds, the 21-year-old, gold in the 200 IM, and 2 world championship titles in this event, goes in 3. Going in lane 5, Song Lingling, a gold medalist in the 100 back, silver medalist in the 200 IM, and bronze medalist in the 100 breast. She's got the complete collection of medals at Rio 2016, but looking for her 4th Games medal. But top qualifier is the world record holder. At her first Paralympic Games, she is the world champion currently. Yelyzaveta Mereshko, 24-year-old, gold in the 100 free and in the 100 breast. Mereshko also perhaps looking to make a point after a disqualification in the 200 IM, where she touched second. But disqualified. So Mereshko is the world record holder. Simmonds is the Paralympic record holder. Simmonds and Mereshko will go side by side. There is Ellie Simmonds. Mereshko beat Simmonds at the Worlds last year, but Simmonds responding with that new world record in April before Mereshko then bettered that again at the European Championships in Portugal in May. This race is undoubtedly one to watch. It is the women's 400 meter freestyle S6. Simmonds in 3, Mereshko in 4, Song in 5, Robinson in 6. Savtsova, Turner with fancy outside chances. Very quickly away then in lane 6 for Ellie Robinson. Mereshko gets into a stroke very quickly, while Eleanor Simmonds will not want to let her get away. Going in lane 2, Savtsova, who does have more of a sprinter background, gets off to a fast start, but will she be able to maintain this sort of pace? That is something that does need to be seen. At the moment, it's Ellie Robinson and Mereshko who are going well, but Song Lingling of People's Republic of China at the 50 is applying some pressure on Savtsova and Mereshko, who touches first.
Mereshko swam that first 50 in 35.39. She has taken it out pretty hard over in lane 2, as you say. Savtsova also having a great first 50. She touched in 3rd just behind Song Lingling. So the Chinese staying in touch easily at the moment with Mereshko, and the youngster Ellie Robinson, the 15-year-old, staying along the line as well. And Ellie Simmonds swimming in 3. She'll just be conserving herself for now. She knows how to swim this race. She knows she's got an extremely strong backhand, excellent endurance. She's hanging tough at the moment. We'll see how it plays out. Mereshko opening up a body length at the 100 split.
So Mereshko is a body length in front, but at the turn, she is being caught by Song Lingling, and indeed, Ellie Robinson is turning on the pace a little here. Eleanor Simmonds is currently fifth overall after the fourth place touch by Saftova going in lane two. Plenty of racing to be done yet. 8 lengths of this Olympic pool. We're only 100 meters in to the 400 free, and seeing that the swimmers are being separated currently by less than 2 body lengths for the first 5. It really is tight.
Be interesting again to see how Mereshko goes on this turn, because we're seeing her open up a bit of a lead and then her turn is costing her dearly, and Song Lingling is very sharp on the turn and comes off the wall really well. So Mereshko still maintaining about 1.5 body lengths, and we can see in the silver medal position at this early stage, things are really evening up across the pool.
Well, they really are. They really are. At the turn, the 4 who are challenging for silver medals at the moment touched within a second of one another, while Mereshko was nearly 4 seconds ahead. This is looking to be Mereshko's race. She beat Simmonds at the Worlds last year. She wants to follow that up with her first Paralympic title in the 400 free. And well, at the 200 mark, she's well in front.
Well, it's an interesting tactic, isn't it? It's taking it out hard and seeing how you can maintain that over the 400. It's such a difficult race. Ellie Simmonds, interestingly, I feel that she's swimming reasonably conservative, but she'd want to be careful here because she's now just dropping slightly off the pace of Song Lingling, the Chinese athlete, and Ellie Robinson showing immense courage, just 15 years of age, staying with Song Lingling stroke for stroke. Ellie Simmonds slightly back at the moment, holding form, but she wouldn't want to drop off the pace anymore. She won't be able to overcome that lead that Mereshko's built so nicely here at the 250 turn.
Well, a good turn at the 250 for Mereshko. It just looks to be slowing down a little. Her lead is increased, but unfortunately for Mereshko, she's starting to swim slower splits. And that is perhaps a little of concern. Eleanor Robinson, by contrast, is swimming a second and a half faster over that last 50. And Ellie Simmonds is looking to catch up as well. So we are seeing some challenges mounted, but Song Lingling is going along in lane 5 as the nearest challenger for now, while Ellie Simmonds in lane 3 is currently up into bronze medal contention after Ellie Robinson has just fallen back ever so slightly, perhaps pushed it a little too hard in the last 250 split. But I doubt any swimmer in the pool can make up this advantage. 3.69 seconds over the last 100. It's going to be a very tough ask for Song Lingling, and an even tougher ask for Simmonds or Robinson. One of those 4 will miss out. Saftova has dropped off now the pace entirely. While at the moment it looks to be going in lane 1, Treo Delgadillo of Mexico will touch 6th. Romano of Italy touching in 7th. The Turner of Ireland will touch 8th overall at the 300 mark.
So Mereshko will lead the field easily into the final turn. Song Lingling in 2nd position at the moment, Simmonds in 3rd. And every time you think that Ellie Robinson has dropped off the pace, she manages to come back and just stay in there and stay in medal contention. She'll touch in 4th, and she's going to need to sprint the final 50 if she wants a medal.
Nobody is going to catch Mereshko now, I'll put it out there, because Mereshko is swimming even faster now than she did at the last leg. But she swam consistent 40-second splits from the 100-meter mark, and that has been the key to her success: consistency. She found her pace, she found her rhythm, she found her tempo. She's getting that stroke rate very consistent at the moment. Yelyzaveta Mereshko, the world champion, the world record holder, is going to claim gold at the Paralympic Games for the first time. Mereshko, in Paralympic record time, claims the gold medal. Silver will go to Song Lingling of China. The defending champion 2 times over settles for bronze. Robinson, the first to miss out on the medals. And finishing in 5th, it'll be Saftova of the Ukraine. But all about Mereshko and that incredible consistency in the pool. 40-second splits the entire way from the 100-meter mark. She showed her ability to plan and swim a good, solid tactical race. Touching 6th in the top lane is Treo Delgadillo of Mexico. 7th is Romano, and Nicole Turner in the 400 free final. S6 touches in 5:54.61, outside her best. But Mereshko, gold medalist in Paralympic record time. Song Lingling of People's Republic of China. Her second silver medal of these championships after the 200 IM, and Eleanor Simmonds. She took gold in the individual medley, but the two-time world champion in this event has not successfully defended the title that she won in Beijing and indeed in London 4 years ago. Mereshko so strong, very powerful. And Eleanor Simmonds the first to congratulate Mereshko. Good, healthy rivalry in the pool. Mereshko of Ukraine, champion of the 403 S6. And now a three-time gold medalist at Rio 2016. Song Lingling in an Asian record, a big PB, 5:21.37, and Eleanor Simmonds, a 5:24.87, takes the bronze.
This is the men's 200 meters individual medley SM7 classification. And if we look through the start lifts here, what a lineup. We've got Huang in lane one, Holup in two, Bogodaiko, the world and Paralympic record holder, the defending champion, in three. Serrano Zarate in four, Garcia Tolson in five, Levy in six, Taras in seven, and Bjornstad in eight. As we introduce the athletes for you, Andreas Skar Bjornstad from Norway. He's 19 years of age, very strong in the breaststroke and the free. It's his first final here in Rio, qualifying time of 2:50.76. Wang Jiang, Jingjiang, swimming in lane one, 25 years of age, already has a bronze in the 50 butterfly. This is his second last event. He was eighth in London. Lario Taras from Italy is 28 years of age, yet to medal at these games. Butterfly and free are his preferred strokes, so we can expect him to go out strongly, but also have a decent finish as well with the free. Tobias Polep, 30 years old, representing Germany. He was eighth in London in this event. He's solid across the free, breast and back. Young business student, 2:46.16, the qualifying time. Australia's Matthew Levy, 29 years of age, yet to medal in Rio. He did win bronze in this event in London, and again, very strong in the free and breaststroke, and we know just how important that technical breaststroke is in the individual medley events. It can be really telling as to who takes home the medal. Evgeny Bogodaiko, well, he is the defending Paralympic champion, 22 years of age. He already has a gold medal in the 100 back and silver in the 50 free and butterfly. Expect a very strong performance from him. Rudy Garcia Tolson from the United States of America, 27 years of age, sixth in the 100 breaststroke. He had silver in London, gold in Beijing, and wouldn't he love to take home a medal, swimming in lane number five. And the fastest qualifier, Carlos Serrano Zarate, 18 years of age and already has a gold in the 100 breaststroke, bronze in the 50 metre free, and the fastest qualifier for this final. The qualifying time, 2:40.58. So Garcia Tolson swam a 2:43.26. It gives you some idea of just what top form Serrano is in. So it will be an enticing duel. We know that Bogodaiko can swim as quick as 2:33.13, which is substantially faster than the qualifying time he swam, but with a busy schedule of events, as do many of these athletes have. Important to do enough to make the final, but still keep some energy in reserve to perform in the final when the medals are on offer. Bogodaiko in three, Serrano in four, Garcia Tolson in five, Levy in six. Well, it was a top start from Taras, the Italian, in lane seven. He's gotten off to a great start. And Matthew Levy as well, as we expected, a strong butterfly. So he's swimming well as well, but Bogodaiko is starting to open up a little of a lead. Wang having a great butterfly leg up in lane one. Reasonably even across the pool, but I suspect Bogodaiko will touch in first after the first 50. Let's take a look at the split. He will touch in first. 30-81, just slightly ahead of Wang, who's in second, and Serrano in third.
Well, it is going to be a very interesting race. It's very tactical and indeed testing for the athletes, because they do need to swim all four strokes in the individual medley, the 250 meters of each of the strokes. First the fly, then the back, then the breast, and then the freestyle to bring them home. And I dare say, if Serrano Zarate is touching within striking distance of a medal come the 100 mark, his breaststroke is sensational and his freestyle is pretty good. He'll fancy himself for gold, silver or bronze at least. Touches fourth overall. Levy of Australia still touching in third, while on his inside, Garcia Tolson, the legendary para-athlete and para-swimmer, is going very strongly. He won gold in this event in 2004 and 2008, and indeed Bogodaiko, the defending champion. But Serrano, watch his breaststroke here. He's now moved up into the shoulder of Levy and will be wanting to get Rudy Garcia Tolson in his sights. But at the moment, Bogodaiko is showing some real impressive strength to stay away on the breaststroke, and still staying in front of Serrano and Levy for the time being, at least, is Garcia Tolson. It's going to come down to the final 50 free sprint.
It will indeed, because Bogodaiko had a fantastic breaststroke leg there. Very, very strong indeed. That technical breaststroke is so important. So it's Bogodaiko all the way at the moment. He's opened up a substantial lead over Garcia Tolson, who's tried to stay in touch, but too easily Bogodaiko has pulled away, and he's swimming well inside his world record at the moment, and it looks extremely comfortable for him. He hardly even looks as if he's pushed himself, and he'll touch in with a world record, with a gold medal. Garcia Tolson, a solid swim, and it's a touch for bronze, and Matt Levy from Australia has just managed to touch in to take the bronze medal. What a fantastic final 25 from him. He fought it out for that medal. So the new world record time, shaving, would you believe it, 2.5 seconds off his old mark. So 2:30.72 for the SM7 world record mark. Garcia Tolson swam a 2:33.87 and Levy 2:36.99, and he was just a tenth of a second in front of Serrano, who will be disappointed with that because he stayed in touch for the entire race and was beaten out, beaten to the post by Levy. But a great swim from the Australian. He'll have his first medal here at Rio.
Well, in the end, it was down to the turns. Serrano lost a lot of time on the turns, really disappointed in that regard. Garcia Tolson, though, was up for the challenge, but the man to beat, Evgeny Bogodaiko, would not be denied. He was great on the turns, good off the starting blocks, and he's mastered all four strokes. While he's certainly strong in the back and free, his breaststroke didn't let him down, and he started very well with a fly as well. So somebody who deserves the gold medal, and to do it in world record time, is just an extra cherry on the proverbial cake for Bogodaiko. That is Rudy Garcia Tolson, and emerging from the pool, that's for Tobias Pollup, who emerged first, but directly behind him was the silver medal, bronze medalist. But Bogodaiko, a very impressive swim once again, and has his second gold at Rio 2016.
Yes, he did. There's Garcia Tolson, the silver medalist, 2:33.87, and 27 years of age. He'll be very pleased with that. Silver in London as well, and of course the gold in Beijing.
Well, there is always a little concern when the official results are not immediately available, and indeed in individual medley races it's not uncommon to see a few turns or strokes question. The technical officials do need to watch a number of factors, and certainly things like how the swimmers perform the dolphin kick, or seeing if there's any symmetry or asymmetry indeed in butterfly stroke, or swimmers not showing intent to touch with an arm that might not be as long as a leading arm. There are several factors that need to be taken into consideration. And the men's 200 individual medley SM7. There are no official results as yet. Anxiously waiting are the respective athletes and nervously looking up at the scoreboard. Garcia, Tolson, and Bogodajko. Well, we have an official who's walking purposely from one end of the pool deck to the other, from the officials' table. And we're heading down to one of the swimmers. So we do have official results. And no disqualifications.
Well, much relief, particularly for the medalists. It's never a nice feeling to be uncertain after the initial results are posted. So Bogodajko will take the gold, and it's silver to the USA and bronze to Australia. The women's 200 metres individual medley SM7 event, and as we look through the start list there, let's hear a big cheer from the crowd. It is much expected. Veronica Almeida will be swimming on the outside lane in lane one, the 41-year-old, much loved here in Rio. Judith Rollo Marquial from Spain, 25 years of age. She's swimming three events here in Rio. She was fifth in the 50 metres butterfly. Well, the crowd absolutely love her. Veronica Almeida, the 41-year-old. She was a butterfly bronze medalist in Beijing, and believe it or not, set a Guinness record in 2015 when she was the fastest person with one arm to swim 10 kilometres in open water. So we know that she has incredible endurance, which will serve her well in the 200 individual medley. Ariana Talamona, 22 years of age. This is her first of four events, and she's another strong backstroker in the lineup. A qualifying time of 3:18.06. Sarah Meehan, 21 years of age. This is her second Paralympics, but she's chasing her first medal. Expect her to go out hard. She's a very strong butterfly. Got some support there in the crowd. You can see in the stands, 30:14.82, her qualifying time. Zhang Ying from China, 25 years of age. She already has a silver in the backstroke. We know the Chinese are so proficient in their backstroke. We can expect her to go super hard because it's her last event here in Rio, so she won't want to leave anything behind, and knowing she doesn't need to conserve any more energy. Courtney Jordan there on your screen from the United States, 25 years of age. She won gold in London in the 50, 100 and 400 freestyle, so we can easily expect her to come home strongly. She also has a silver from the 50 metres butterfly here in Rio. 3:08.84 was her qualifying time. Tess Ratliff, you can see on your screen, just 17 years of age. She had a silver in the individual medley at Worlds in 2015. The young student has a full schedule here, swimming eight events. And Nikita Howarth, the outright favourite to win gold in this event, 17 years of age. She has a bronze in the 50 metres butterfly. She was sixth in this event in London when she was a very young member of the New Zealand team, and she won the 2015 individual medley at the World Championships, so she is a world champion in this event. She will swim from four. So Almeida in one, Meehan in two, Jordan in three, Howarth 4, Routliff 5, Zhang in 6, Talamona from Italy in 7, and Rollo Marquial from Spain in 8. the women's 200 metres individual medley SM7 classification. World record time is 2:48.43, set way back in 2010 by Mallory Wegerman from the United States. The Paralympic record has stood for the last 4 years from Jacqueline Freeney from Australia. Great reaction time there from Nikita Howarth. We know we've seen her swimming so quickly off the blocks, and she's capitalising now, so settling in nicely with the difficult butterfly leg. Such a grueling endurance event, the 200 metres IM, and it's even across the pool with Howarth, Jordan and Meehan in 4, 3 and 2 respectively. So New Zealand, USA and Canada looking to take the early lead at the first 50 metre split.
Well, I don't think Nikita Howarth or Courtney Jordan should at any stage be discounted, but neither should Sarah Meehan. She's very strong on the fly. She's a bronze medalist at the World Championships in the 50 fly, and she's got a very strong backstroke, and she's got the endurance. She's often doing cross-country skiing. Her younger sisters, Hannah and Heather, are actually competed internationally at cross-country skiing, so she's got the endurance and the added benefit of the aerobic exercise behind her in the pool. But at the moment, it's Courtney Jordan hanging on to second place. Battle for first place will be, you imagine, between Jordan and Nikita Howarth. But the bronze medalist in the fly is world champion over this distance in 2013 and 2015. And Nikita Howarth wants to make this race count. She wants to claim her first Paralympic gold medal, and she wants to do it in an event in which she is the world champion. At the moment, there's not a great deal in it because a fantastic swim from Chan Ying going in lane six sees her back into contention at the halfway mark.
Well, we knew that Zhang Ying was going to have a strong backstroke, and it certainly proved to be the case. It was enough to put her into second position. Howarth, though, was fantastic off the wall. She had a great turn, timed it perfectly, and pushed off into her breaststroke, and as a result has grown her advantage to, well, it could well be about 4 body lengths at this stage. She's in front of Jordan, who's swimming well in lane 3, but if she's not careful, she's going to drop right out of gold medal contention. The silver medal battle, however, is going to be extremely enticing as Howarth swims into the wall for the 150 split. She's going to be feeling fantastic. She looks like she's doing it easily, and she'll almost certainly be able to bring home gold from here.
Well, this is a very, very good swim. The breaststroke leg by Nikita Howarth was thoroughly impressive, and certainly the New Zealander is looking well set to claim the title in the women's 200 individual medley. The battle for silver has now seen Tess Routliffe make a charge for it. The New Zealand-born Tess Routliffe might make it a New Zealand-born 1-2, but Tess Routliffe has made a big challenge here, and certainly somebody who shot to prominence at the Parapans in the 200 IM. And Tess Routliffe is doing something extraordinary in the pool. She suddenly moved up into medal contention, is holding on for the silver, but the focus on the gold medalist here by some margin as well.
Nikita Howarth bringing it home strongly. She'll be outside her best, I believe, but she's had a wonderful swim. Look at this, touching ahead easily to take home the gold medal, and a fantastic performance from the Canadian Routliffe, touching in for silver. What a lovely finish from her. And Courtney Jordan from the United States will take the bronze. In the end, Routliffe had a fantastic swim, particularly over the final 25. She really pulled ahead of Jordan. But the event goes to Howarth, Nikita Howarth, 17 years of age, adding to her medal collection. Bronze already in the 50 butterfly, and this will make it all the sweeter. And that's Rollo Marquiel from Spain will touch out the field to finish in 8th position. With smiles all round for Nikita Howarth, 2:57.29. So marginally quicker than her qualifying time in the heats. And Tess Routliffe, 3:02.05, to take the silver. So So as you could see, it was all from the start, really. Howarth just so quick off the blocks, and it sets her up so well. It gives early confidence, particularly with the butterfly. And there wasn't much in it at the first turn. The backstroke leg was interesting. Howarth managed to build her lead, and the Chinese athlete had a surge, Jang, as we expected. But ultimately finished out of the medals. But there's Team New Zealand enjoying such success at these games, with a number of athletes absolutely firing in the pool, and a lovely moment of congratulations between the New Zealand athlete and the American.
Well, that is a moment of delight for Nikita Howarth. Courtney Jordan, her 10th Paralympic Games medal now. It just happens to be a bronze. Historic silver medal for Tess Routliff as well. Three finals, no medals so far, but a strong breaststroke leg set her up for a silver, which she claimed at the World Champs last year as well. This is the men's 100 meter freestyle S10. Two Brazilians go in this race, André Brasil and Felipe Rodrigues. But it's Vanhoof, Brasil, Rodrigues, Kripak, Dubrov, Crothers, Stein, and Vanchenko. Three Ukrainian swimmers, two Brazilian swimmers, a Canadian, an Australian, and a Dutch swimmer. First to be introduced, 20-year-old Dmitry Vanchenko will go in eight. Willefeer van der Voort goes in lane one for the Netherlands. A 54.77 for van der Voort. Nathan Steyn of Canada goes in lane seven, the 24-year-old. Now the medals should come from lanes two to six. Two will miss out. André Brasil, gold medalist in 2008, gold medalist in 2012. The 32-year-old goes in lane two. Going in lane six, the Commonwealth champion, Rowan Crothers, a man they call Magnet. He used to be a water polo player, and apparently on a few occasions the ball hit him on the head, almost as if the ball was drawn to his head. Felipe Rodrigues goes in lane three. Silver medalist in 2008, silver medalist in 2012, both times behind Brasil. The 26-year-old 53 silver medalist goes in lane three. Well, the two favorites for the gold and silver, Denis Dubrov, the 27-year-old, already two gold medals, gold in the 100 fly and the 200 IM. Silver and two bronze for Dubrov. Maxim Kripak of Ukraine is the favorite in lane four. Gold in the 53, gold in the 100 back, and now looking to complete the 50 and 100 free double. Kripak qualified fastest, but separated by less than half a second were Kripak, Dubrov and Rodrigues. Still the world record holder is André Brasil, now approaching his 33rd birthday, perhaps past his best. But he is looking to prove the doubters wrong and looking to show that indeed he's still got the ability to not only swim well, swim strong, but win races, claim medals. Now, this is Dubrov. Dubrov amongst the greatest medal hauls of this competition so far. Five medals in total, including two golds. Van der Voort, Brasil, Rodrigues, Kripak, Dubrov, Crothers, Steyn, and Vanchenko. Very good start in lane three for Felipe Rodrigues. André Brasil hits the water and looks to hit the front. He's up alongside Felipe Rodrigues. The two Ukrainians just trailing behind the two Brazilians for now. But Kripak is looking to launch a fight back, and Dubrov comes into his own in this 100. Watch out for Crothers as well. He's got a strong back end. The Commonwealth champion won the Glasgow 2014 gold in very comfortable fashion. Touches fifth overall. This is certainly going to be an intriguing finish to this title, because after the turn, it is Kuipak and Rodriguez who are leading. Andre Brazil shaping up for a bronze medal. Duvrov with a poor turn, lost out a little. Rodriguez is challenging for the gold. It's Kuipak who's leading. The pride of Brazil, the pride of Ukraine. Who's going to edge out? Brazil making a chance for silver. It's going to be Kuipak, surely. Kuipak, Duvrov closing fastest. Kuipak will take the gold. Brazil claims the silver. Duvrov doesn't even place as Rodriguez takes the bronze. That's as close as we've seen to the roof coming off at the Olympic Aquatic Stadium. Felipe Rodriguez beats Andre Brazil. Brazil rather beats Rodriguez, but Maxim Kuipak, a European record, 51.08. He's only 1/100th of a second outside the Paralympic record set by Brazil. Brazil, a silver medal. Well, the cheer for the Brazilian, for the Ukrainians. Dubrov will feel shattered. He was making a very big bid for the bronze, at least with a fast close, but how strong was the finish by Felipe Rodriguez? Dubrov, a poor turn at the top end of the pool, though, just put him out of medal contention. Crothers only touching fifth overall.
Yeah, it just proves how costly it can be in this. Well, it's an all-out sprint, and if you time your turn to perfection and capitalize on that, you set yourself up for the final 50. It didn't happen for Dubrov, but what a fantastic result for the Brazilian crowd. Silver and bronze, and Kuipak there rightly celebrating his achievements, and you can see the emotion on the face of the Brazilians. What could possibly be better than swimming in front of a home crowd? And they're very thankful for it as well. Look at that.
Andre Brazil, Felipe Rodriguez alongside one another acknowledge this delighted crowd at Rio 2016. They finish in silver and bronze respectively. Dubrov misses out completely despite five medals at these championships already. But Maxim Kuipak, look at the top four. They are within 0.51 of one another. That's virtually half a second separating the top four. That is a phenomenal swim. Carruthers set an Oceania record to touch fifth overall. But Kuipak has completed the 50 and 100 free double. The final now of the women's 100 meter freestyle is dead. More Brazilian representation in the final. This time it is Mariana Ribeiro who goes in seven. Osteres, Chen, Lurandi, Rivard, Pasco, Krieger, Ribeiro, and Cristino of Mexico. Going in lane eight for Mexico, Stephanie Ruby, Cristino Zapata, simply Ruby to her family who are sitting in the stands. Maria Osteres of the Netherlands goes in lane one, the 21-year-old swimming just outside a 1:03 in qualifying. Her family too in the stands. Brazil's representation will swim in lane seven, Mariana Ribeiro, the 21-year-old, a 1:02.84 in the heats. A swimmer you cannot discount. She's only 15 years old, still learning her trade, but already a gold in the mixed 50 relay, the 4x50 mixed relay, silver in the 100 fly, and bronze in the 50 free. Lisa Krieger of the Netherlands goes in lane six, gold in the 100 breaststroke, not her strongest event, but good solid Dutch representation with Osteres and Krieger in lanes one and six. Now we move to the favorites. Elodie Lurandi, silver medalist 4 years ago, the 27-year-old former 400 meter freestyle champion. Lurandi plans to retire after the World Championships next year, wants to make this a grand exit from the Paralympic Games. Going in lane five, aiming for a fourth gold medal in 4 days, Sophie Pasco, who won the title 4 years ago in London, goes in lane five. But the friendly rivalry between Pascoe and Rivard continues here, because the world champion, Aurelie Rivard of Canada, goes in lane four. She finished outside the medals in London. She touched fourth, but now vastly more experienced as a 20-year-old, returns and has already claimed gold in the 50 free and is looking to round out the 50 and 100 free double. She's the world record holder. She set a Paralympic record in qualifying as the only swimmer to go sub 60 seconds in the heats. A silver in the 200 IM behind Pascoe. She often trades with her twin sister Charlotte, her father of sporting background. He was a goalkeeper, a hockey goalkeeper in Canada. Sophie Pascoe. She lost to Rivard in the 50 free in her very first race at Rio 2016, then won gold in the 100 back, gold in the 200 IM, and gold in the 100 fly. Osterreis, Chen, Lohandi, Rivard, Pascoe, Krieger, Ribeiro, and Cristino. The final of the women's 100 freestyle S10, eagerly anticipated. Rivard, such quick reaction time. Sophie Pascoe, a little less distance off the starting block, but quickly into her stroke. It is Rivard who is looking to dominate here, while Lohandi of France goes strong in lane three, but is just losing that little pace. Going strong in lane two, though, is Chen Yi, the 15-year-old from China, but much will depend on her turn. While making a charge from the opening lane, the first lane, Osterreis of the Netherlands. But right now, it is Rivard ahead of Pascoe, ahead of Lohandi.
Let's see how they come off the wall. And Rivard's had a really good turn, but she still hasn't managed to extend the lead over Pascoe. In fact, they're going to be going pretty much stroke by stroke as they enter the final 25. The Chinese athlete just starting to drop off a little. Chen Yi, she had a great first 50, tiring a little.
Well, Sophie Pascoe is chasing Rivard, but Rivard's starting to pull away. She's just off her own world record pace. She's going to go sub 60 seconds, though. Rivard is going to beat out the closing Pascoe. Rivard takes gold, Pascoe takes silver, and bronze goes to Lohandi, the silver medalist of 4 years ago. France with a rare swimming medal at Rio 2016. But Rivard does not disappoint. She completes the 50 and 100 free double. The world record holder sets a new Paralympic record in 59.31. And first to congratulate her is Sophie Pascoe. Words for one another. A very healthy rivalry between them. Sophie Pascoe, so much would have depended on her recovery. She has been swimming in five consecutive days, and ice baths and massages needed to be keep her going. Lohandi takes this bronze for France.
Well, it was a great start off the blocks. Actually, most athletes did pretty well. In the end, it was Chen Yi who had the quickest reaction time just ahead of Rivard. But the turn, so crucial, and we know that Rivard set herself up so well heading into that final 50. And as you say, perhaps Pascoe just a little tired after an extremely busy 4 days of competition, well, consecutive days, and swimming in finals every day. And what a great result for her to back up and get a silver.
A little English and French-Canadian triangle. Lohandi, the French speaker, Rivard from Quebec, but fluent in English and French, and Pascoe, the English speaker of New Zealand, also goes sub the previous Paralympic record, but still not good enough to claim the gold. Rivard, Paralympic record time, not far away from her own world record, claims the gold. And Lohandi, silver medalist of 4 years ago, touches for bronze. Sophie Pascoe, the medalist again, however.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 200 meters individual medley SM6.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos 200.
This is the men's 200 meters individual medley SM6 victory ceremony, which was delayed from day 5 due to a disqualification and then a protest, and ultimately Nelson Crispin Corzo was disqualified from that race, which gives us the final standings of the race of Sasha Kindred in gold, Jia Hongguang from China in silver, and Talisson Glock from Brazil edges into the bronze medal position, which will delight the local crowd. You can see there the man on your screen, Sasha Kindred, a veteran of
the
Paralympics.
Member of the Paralympic
so
order.
Much success, and manages to just keep dazzling
Lord
in his decorated career. So Lord Chris Holmes to present the medals, and
will
be assisted by Martin Mansell, who's a former member of the International Paralympic Committee.
Mr. Martin Mansell. The bronze medalist representing Brazil.
Medalha de bronze representando o Brasil, Talisson Glock.
Well, huge cheers for Talisson Glock. He steps into the bronze medal position. He had to wait to find out overnight whether this would be the case, but swimming the final in a time of 2:41.39, that is the men's 200 metres individual medley, SM6.
Silver medalist representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de prata representando a República Popular da China.
Jia Hongguang.
Jia Hongguang, try as he might, desperate to claim his first ever Paralympic Games gold medal. Silver in London 4 years ago. In the 100 back. Silver in the 100 back in Rio 2016. After a bronze in the 53, is now a silver medalist in the men's 200 individual medley, SM6. A fourth Paralympic Games medal for the Chinese swimmer. Could not deny Kindred a seventh gold medal at the Paralympic Games.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Great Britain.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico representando a Grã-Bretanha.
Sasha Kindred.
What a moment for Sasha Kindred, receiving his seventh Paralympic gold medal, his 13th overall. Only three other British male swimmers have that many medals, and he did it in world record time of 2:38.47. He won this event in Athens and Beijing, but had to settle for silver in London. So he will feel that the universe has been tipped back to equilibrium as he takes this gold medal. What a moment for him. It was quite a journey to get there. He was disqualified in his heat. That disqualification overturned, and he responded with that world record breaking performance to take the gold medal.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Great Britain.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Grã-Bretanha. senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas paralímpicos.
Well, there you have it. Finally, they do receive the medals for their event that was swum on day 5 of competition. It is, of course, now day 6 of competition at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. And Sasha Kindred, now the world record holder in the men's 200 metres individual medley SM6, flanked by the Chinese and Brazilian athletes. And fair to say, is having a wonderful reception here at the Olympic Aquatic Stadium. Plenty of British supporters in the crowd as he celebrates his 7th Paralympic gold medal, an extraordinary achievement at 38 years of age. And as we mentioned, his 13th overall medal. Friends looking on from the crowd there, and
ladies and gentlemen,
this is the victory ceremony for the women's 400 meter freestyle S6.
Women's 400 meters freestyle S6.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos 400 metros nado livre feminino S6 dos Jogos Paralímpicos Rio 2016. Gentileza, dê as boas-vindas às medalhistas.
The medals will be presented by governing board member of the
Dwayne Kale, the governing board member of the International Paralympic Committee, will present the medals.
Paralímpico Internacional,
Mr. Dwayne Kale, to be accompanied by,
he will be accompanied by Commander of the 1st Battalion of Guard, Colonel Sergio Ramos.
Senhor Coronel Sergio Moraes Ramos Carneiro.
Bronze medalist representing Great Britain.
Medalha de bronze, representando a Grã-Bretanha.
Representing Great Britain,
Eleanor Simmonds,
the two-time defending champion, beaten in one of her favorite events. The event she won as a 13-year-old historically in Beijing, and that she managed to retain the title in London 4 years ago. One of the poster girls of the Paralympic Games of 4 years ago, Ellie Simmonds. A two-time world champion as well in this event. Beaten into silver in last year's World Championships, now takes a bronze at the Paralympic Games of 2016.
Silver medalist representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de prata representando a República Popular da China.
Song Lingling.
Song Lingling, the 20-year-old, she swam an Asian record to win this silver medal. She was bronze in Beijing in this event, so she'll be very happy to be moving up the medal placings. And already at these games, has a gold in the women's 100-metre backstroke S6 and a bronze in the 100 breast as well. So, still one event to come for her, and so she'll enjoy this and take a lot of confidence out of that swim. Song Lingling.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Ukraine.
Medalha de ouro, campeã paralímpica representando a Ucrânia.
Yelyzaveta Mereshko.
At her first Paralympic Games, Yelyzaveta Mereshko in Paralympic record time of 5:17.01 takes the gold medal to add to her goal in the 100 free and indeed in the 100 breast. She set her first European record only 2 years ago at the European Championships 2014 in the Netherlands. And she has improved tremendously over the last 2 years in anticipation of Rio 2016. And making a point after the DQ in the 200 IM, Yelyzaveta Mereshko is champion in the 400 freestyle and a three-time gold medalist at Rio 2016.
The anthem of Ukraine.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Ucrânia.
Senhoras e senhores, as medalhistas paralímpicas.
The Paralympic medalists, two-time defending champion Ellie Simmonds takes the bronze. Song Lingling of the People's Republic of China with a fine bronze medal. And gold to Yelyzaveta Mereshko, her third at Rio 2016.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 400 meters freestyle S6.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos 400 metros nado livre masculino S6 dos Jogos.
Now for the victory ceremony in the men's 400 meter freestyle S6. The medalists from Italy, Netherlands, and Cuba.
Bronze medalist representing Cuba.
Medalha de bronze representando Cuba. Lorenzo Perez Escalona.
Lorenzo Perez Escalona of Cuba. Fourth in the 53 and by an agonizing margin at that, missed out on a medal. But the 30-year-old swam in America's record to just claim the bronze medal. And a big thumbs up for the crowd, Cuban. Two medals in London, a silver in the 50 free and a bronze in the 100 free. Now in the 400 free, he collects a bronze 4 years on.
Silver medalist representing the Netherlands.
Medalha de prata representando Países Baixos.
Tyus van Hofwegen.
The silver medalist, Tyus van Hofwegen, the 19-year-old, who's thrilled with his performance, his first Paralympic medal. He's swimming six events here in Rio, hadn't managed to medal until then, and what a moment for him at just 19 years of age. Young man who lists his interests as tennis, gaming, and swimming is listed as a hobby, would you believe? But I'm sure he takes it a little more seriously than that, and if not, he will from now on. The silver medalist, Van Hofwegen.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion, representing Italy.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico, representando a Itália.
But the champion is from Italy, Francesco Bucciardo of Italy, the 22-year-old from Genoa, came to Rio 2016 to prove that his world title was no fluke, and indeed did so. Bucciardo of Italy. Not yet the world record holder, but a world champion in a Paralympic Games gold is a pretty good start in an event. And he'll hope to augment those titles in the years ahead. A few in the audience clapping along enthusiastically to the Italian national anthem. Perez takes the bronze, Van Hofwegen takes the silver, and Bucciardo of Italy takes the gold. A 5:02.15, but all he needed to do was beat every other swimmer in the field, and he did that, Bucciardo. Joins the likes of Morlacci as Italian champions at Rio 2016. Massimiliano Tosin, the Italian swimming coach, will be very proud of his swimmers' achievements throughout Rio 2016. Smiles for the cameras, fist pumps for the cameras.
the men's 100 metres breaststroke SB11 final. And what a battle this is going to be. As we look down the start list, we have the world record and Paralympic record holder in Yang Bozun swimming out of the third lane. He wasn't the quickest qualifier by a long shot. In fact, a second and a half ahead was Maschenko. So we introduce the athletes for you. That's Yunerki Ortega, 26-year-old, who missed the final in London. He's Cuba's Para Athlete of the Year in 2011. Miroslav Smirka, 52 years of age. He competed for his nation for many years in the able-bodied swimming before losing his eyesight in 2011. So a very experienced campaigner. 1:23.65 was his qualifying time. Brian Urbano Herrera, 22 years of age. This is the first of four events he's swimming at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. Breast and free are his preferred strokes. So expect a strong performance from him. And in lane two, we have Viktor Smirnov, 30 years of age. He's a free and fly gold medalist, and he did win a gold in the individual medley in Beijing. Multiple medals across his Paralympic career. And from the United States, Theron Drake, 23 years of age. He won a silver in the 400 free already, so we know he has great endurance. He had a few months off last year after surgery. Yang Bozun, the world and Paralympic record holder, based in the port city of Tianjin, just outside Beijing. He's already won a bronze in the 50 free. He is the reigning Paralympic champion. Swimming in lane five for Japan, Keiichi Kimura. He already has a silver in the 50 metres free. The 26-year-old was eighth in the individual medley in London. He's also the executive director of Japan's Paralympic Committee, so a very busy man indeed. And here we have the fastest qualifier for this event, Alexander Maschenko. He won gold medals in Beijing, Athens, and Sydney. He's yet to win a medal, however, here in Rio, and he'd dearly love to win the gold in the men's 100 metres backstroke. SB11 classification for vision-impaired athletes. The athletes must wear blackened goggles, and they're checked straight after the race by officials to make sure they're entirely blackened, so as no athlete has an advantage over their competitors. So we're almost ready to start here. The world record set in London 4 years ago, 1:10.11. Qualifying times as a whole have been well outside that mark. Yang Bozun has been spending a little time away from swimming, focusing on his career. So what does he have here when it matters most? Well, it was a lovely start by Kimura, in fact, who had the best of it off the blocks. A 0.68 reaction time and settling in very nicely to the first 25 or so. And it actually looks as though Yang Bozun has taken it out extremely hard. He's leading by half a body length at the moment. Maschenko just sitting on his left-hand shoulder, but he'll easily take it into the one and only turn of this race. And it'll be a pretty sharp 50-metre split, I would think, 32.58.
Very close between second, third and fourth overall, but it is Yang Bozun who leads, saved a lot of energy in the heats, but it's Kimura second, third Maschenko, and Theron Drake is really looking good in lane six currently. But at the moment, the world record pace is just about out of reach for Yang Bozun, but he is swimming well despite having lost his cap.
Well, he has just lost his cap about 15 metres out from the finish line, an unwelcome distraction. He's just off world record pace. The fight is on for the minor placings, but Yang Bozun, he has touched in world record time, 1:10.08. 0.03 of a second beneath his previous mark, and Drake will take the silver. Kimura in the bronze, but Yang Bozun, the 30-year-old from Tianjin, a stunning performance. He went out hard, took it out extremely hard, and almost completed, you'd have to think, the perfect race.
Well, it was a clinical race from Yang Bozun, the Chinese swimmer, who knew he couldn't expend too much energy in the heats and only drawn in lane three. But Tharren Drake, a very clever swim from him in a very strong back 25. Solid on the turn at the top end as well, as he only touched fourth quickest to Ichikimura, silver medalist 4 years ago. Silver in the 53 already, the former world champion. Japan's flag bearer at the London Paralympic Games settles for bronze. And Maschenko, amazingly, after being within striking distance of winning the silver, the gold medalist in 2000, 2004 and 2008, has missed out on a medal in his third race at Rio 2016. The 53 and the 100 back, he's already missed out medals on as well. But Yang Bozun, how's that for a finish? He just increased his speed, increased his energy, and he's exhausted himself. He had one big race in him, and he saved it for the final and wins in world record time.
Yes, and lost his cap in the process. Perhaps he was swimming so quick there was no option but for it to pop off. He's done extremely well. Kimura there, very happy. But the moment belongs to Yang Bozun. World record time, 1:10.08. The previous mark was 1:10.11. So just shaving 0.03 of a second off there. Drake in second with 1:11.50 and Kimura 1:12.88, rounding out the field. Maschenko, as we said, had to miss out on the medal on the medals in fourth. Smirnov in fifth. Urban Herrera in sixth. The women's 100 metres breaststroke SB11 classification. There was no heat for this event. Straight into the finals, and we look at the lineup there: Italy in one, Argentina in two, China in three, the Netherlands in four, with Brainsma, who would be the favourite for this event, Reichard in five, Berezhna in six, and Martinez in seven. So Rabellini from Italy, Martina Rabellini, 18 years of age. We know that she can swim 1:28 at her best. It could be enough to challenge for a medal here. This is the first of six events she's swimming in Rio, and it's in a final. So she'll need those nerves to settle early. Leticia Martinez from the United States. She's based in Colorado Springs. Eighth in this event in London. The 21-year-old was fourth at the Worlds in 2015. And she's also swimming the first of five events here in Rio. Nadia Baez. She was a bronze medalist in London in the 100 metres breast. 27 years of age. Lost her vision completely at the age of 15 from retinal cancer. Yana Berezhna from Ukraine, 19 years of age. She was the silver medalist in London, and this is her opening event as well, the first of three events for her in this, the SB11 100 breaststroke. Zhang Xiaotong, 17 years of age, hails from Liaoning province. In China, this is her only event at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. She'd dearly love a medal here. Maya Reichard from Sweden. Some Swedish supporters in the crowd. And she was silver in the 50 metre free, bronze in the 100 metres back. She's the defending Paralympic champion and was Sweden's flag bearer for the opening ceremony. What can she achieve? And we look to the Dutch supporters there as Brainsma, that is Lisette Brainsma, 16 years of age. She's won gold in the 400 metres free and bronze in the 50 metres free. We'll have to fancy her chances at the gold medal here. So the gold medal likely to come in lanes 3, 4 and 5, Zhang, Brainsma and Reichard. Reichard, the defending Paralympic champion, 25 years of age. Brainsma just 16 years of age and already two medals in Rio. So the world record time held by Brainsma set in the Netherlands in her home in April this year, 124.63 is the mark. And we know that's how fast she'll swim at her best. Well, it was Brainsma who was strong out of the blocks, but Rijkaard also has had a terrific start and stroking strongly. It's neck and neck at the moment, but don't discount Jang in lane three as well. She's actually making up ground, and if not, will open up a slim margin as they come in for the first turn. So it is Jang, the 17-year-old, her debut here at London, here at Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. She will touch in at the wall first and about half a body length in front.
Well, it looks like Zhang is swimming the clever race. She's gone out very hard and she touches almost 2 seconds ahead of Brainsma and Rijkaard, who are far more fancied in this race. But Brainsma and Rijkaard lost their way, where Brainsma actually veered off to one side and Rijkaard veered almost into the same lane rope at one stage. It looked like they touched in the pool during the stroke. It's just disrupted the rhythm of both the swimmers, but taking nothing away from Zhang's swim. It's been perfectly timed, and she's really launched an assault on the title here.
Well, Zhang touched at the 50 turn in world record time and just looking so fantastic. I don't think they can touch her now, and she's going to set a new mark if she can keep this up for the final 10 metres. She's going so strongly. She's looking like she could break the record, and she has. What a fantastic swim. A touch for second. Brainsma will settle for the silver and Rijkaard for the bronze. Well, Zhang Xiaotang, her first event here in Rio. We knew she was quick at the turn because she was under world record pace, 123.02. Well, extraordinary. She's beaten the previous mark by almost, well, over half a second, a second and a half, which is a fantastic result for her. Lisette Brainsma, she's just had her world record broken. She'll be disappointed with that, but it was a class act, really, from the Chinese swimmer. There was no catching her on that final 50. And Maya Rijkaard, 126.60. Swimming a little slower than the qualification time she'd posted to qualify for this final.
Well, Zhang keeping a lot in reserve, but this is the moment I spoke about where the swimmers, well, this is not the moment, is yes, it is, where they were virtually touching each other underwater before they'd hit the lane ropes, realized they were swimming side by side and that they had been veering off just a little to the side. It was Rijkaard who was veering to the right and Brainsma veering to the left. But there was only one swimmer who was in it. The question was whether or not she would break the world record after going out so hard and under world record pace, that touch at the 50-meter mark. The goggles being inspected in an event that'll see all swimmers have their goggles inspected, must swim with blacked-out goggles. But a world record to claim the gold ahead of the world record holder who came into this event. And Brainsma with a quiet word for the Chinese swimmer.
So look at the final confirmed results there, and Zhang Xiaotong, the gold medalist in commanding fashion, it has to be said. Brainsma from the Netherlands, Rijkaard from Sweden in the bronze, Berezna from the Ukraine in fourth position, Baez from Argentina in fifth, Martinez from the USA in sixth, and Rabellini from Italy in seventh. The men's 100 metres backstroke SB12 classification. And if we look down that starting list, very, very interesting final indeed. Not much between the fastest qualifiers in this event. Izatau, who holds the Paralympic record, will swim from lane four. Fabrizio Sottile from Italy, 23 years old. He made the final in London in the individual medley and 400 free. This isn't his preferred event, but he's done well to make the final. Daniel Simon from Germany will swim in lane one. He was 11th in London, so it's a good result for him to make the final here. 27 years of age. It's the first of two events. We'll also see him compete in the 50 metres free. Maxim Varaxa, 32 years of age, a triple gold medalist in London in the individual medley and the freestyle 100 metres and 50. So he's hugely experienced in bronze in London in this event. Sergei Klipet from Ukraine, we can expect him big things from him. He's had most success in free and backstroke events and won plenty of medals in previous Paralympics, but not in this event. Daniel Giraldo Correa from Colombia. The Colombians are having such a good time here in Rio. He was seventh in London in this event, first of four events here in Rio. Anur Akhmatov was 12th in London, so again, another first-time finalist. 23 years of age, he's taken 3 seconds off the time he swam in London, so a big improvement there. Dimitri Saleh, he'll swim from lane five. He was fourth in London, so disappointment for him. Can he right it now? He also won gold in the butterfly in London. Formerly competed for Belarus. He has 6 events in Rio. And the world record holder for Belarus, rather the Paralympic record holder for Belarus, is Udzimir Izatau, 28 years of age. He set that Paralympic record in his heat. This is his pet event. He was a silver medalist in London and bronze in Beijing, a steady improver. He'd really like the gold medal in Rio. So Izatau swimming from lane four, setting the qualifying time of 107.28, which was a Paralympic record in the early heat on day 6. Saleh from Azerbaijan, the closest to him in terms of qualifying, he said a 108.68 will swim in lane 5. The next quickest was Akhmatov, who will swim in 3. Well, it was a good start from Izatau, but there wasn't much in it. All swimmers had reasonable reaction times off the blocks there, and Izatau looking to build a lead early. He's taken it out hard. He doesn't want to leave anything behind, and he really wants to place himself in gold medal position because we know he has strength on the back end here. So they head into the wall for the first and only turn. It'll be Izatau, but he's being pushed.
Well, Akhmatov is going to push him, and certainly Dimitri Saleh is desperate to get back to winning medals at the Paralympic Games, and indeed a former champion, not in this event however. He just wants that taste of medals at the Paralympic Games again. But watch out for Veraskza of Ukraine going in lane 7. He's made a charge after the turn, and I think he's just dropped Kazakhstan's Akhmatov in the third lane.
Yes, well, Veraskza is trying to put himself into silver medal position, and gee, that's going to be a tough battle. But at the moment it's all about Izatau. He's gliding towards the line, looking relatively unchallenged. It'll be well outside his best, but oh, he set a Paralympic record, I beg your pardon. What a great swim from Izatau. Saleh will take the silver and Rivard the bronze medal. So it's the swimmer from Belarus who broke the previous mark that he set to qualify for this final. He'll take the gold in a Paralympic record time of 106.82.
Dimitri Saleh will take the bronze medal, the silver medal rather. He's the fly champion some years ago, and he failed to medal in 2016 so far. Coming into this race, needed to make it count, and he did. And going to Ukraine, the bronze medal, as Veraskza swam a fine race, but Izatau looked supreme. Well, after the disappointment of the silver in 2012, suddenly started to show his prowess. He's gone on to win the last two World Championship titles.
Well, it was a fantastic lead into the wall. He timed it to perfection, and really what it was that second 50. He set himself up so well and just looked like he was untouchable. It was a tight battle for silver. But there he is, the 2016 Rio Paralympic Games champion. all three athletes congratulating each other. It's always a good moment to relax and celebrate the achievements. So there we have the final standings. Izatau with the gold, Saleh the silver, Varaxa with the bronze. Akhmatov has to settle for fourth position. Klippert, Giraldo Correa in sixth, Simon from Germany in seventh, and Satil from Italy in eighth.
The Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 200 meters individual medley SM7.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos 200 metros da do medley masculino classe SM7.
The victory ceremony for the men's 200 meters individual medley SM7. What a race it was as the athletes take their positions. And it's Evgeny Bogodarko from Ukraine. You can see on your screen there, 22 years of age and setting a world record in that final.
Medals have been presented 230-72. Technical Committee of IPC Swimming.
As medalhas serão entregues pela presidente do Comitê Técnico Esportivo de Natação do Comitê Paralímpico Internacional.
Miss Jane,
Jane D. Blaine is the IPC Swimming Chairwoman. Will present the medals.
International Paralympic Committee.
Ela acompanhada pelo ex-membro do Comitê Paralímpico Internacional.
Mr. Martin Mansell.
International Paralympic Committee, former member of.
Bronze medalist representing Australia.
Medalha de bronze representando Australia.
Matthew Levy,
the 29-year-old. This is his first medal at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. What a moment for him. He did win medals in London and Beijing, so this will make it all the sweeter.
Thank you very much.
His time, 236.99, to take the bronze. So Matthew Levy, still another three events to swim in Rio. We'll enjoy this moment.
Silver medalist representing the United States of America.
Medalha de prata representando os Estados Unidos da América.
Rudy Garcia Tolson.
This is one of the more fascinating life stories. Rudy Garcia Tolson, now 27, champion in 2004, champion in 2008. The first para athlete with an above knee amputation to complete a triathlon unassisted. A man who was born with multiple birth defects, 15 surgeries before he was 5 years old. And before he was eight, told his parents he would rather have his legs amputated above the knee. What he's gone on to achieve since is nothing short of tremendous. He's completed triathlons. He's competed for the United States in athletics. And again, he stands on the podium as a swimming medalist. Incredible.
Representing Ukraine.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico, representando a Ucrânia.
Yevgeny Bogodarko,
the 22-year-old, has already tasted such success at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. This is his second gold medal. The men's 200 meters individual medley SM7, and recovering from a nasty injury back in 2012 where he broke an arm and tore his Achilles tendon as well. Recovered from that to aim solely and squarely for success at the Rio 2016 Games, and he's having a fantastic swim meet here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Ukraine.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Ucrânia.
Música.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Paralympic the medalists for the men's 200 metres individual medley SM7 classification, warmly congratulating each other. And we'll see a bit more of these athletes in the final stages of the swimming competition here at the Olympic Aquatic Stadium. All three have very busy schedules, but we'll take a pause from that. Garcia Tolson, of course, America's record, and Matthew Levy setting an oceanic record. As for what could be said as a very high quality final, with of course Bogodarko setting the world record in the process of 230.72. Pretty happy Ukrainian fans in the crowd there, and they have every reason to be, because the medals just keep on coming for the Ukrainian team.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and the women's 200 metres individual medley SM7 victory ceremony. What a great race it was.
De premiação dos 200 metros já do medley feminino, classe SM7 dos Jogos Paralímpicos.
The medals for this category: New Zealand, Canada, and the United States.
Please welcome
Nikita Haworth. You can see the gold medalist in the middle of the group, just 17 years of age, and winning the race in 2:57.29, a commanding victory. Ahead of Routliff from Canada in 302.05 and Jordan from the United States in 304.17.
Bronze medalist representing the United States of America.
Medalha de bronze representando os Estados Unidos da América.
Courtney Jordan.
Well, Courtney Jordan has a lot of support here at Rio. There's a big Canadian team, and they call her Team Mum because she's always looking after other people. From the United States of America. One gold in London in the 50, 100 and 400 free. We expected her to come home strongly, and she did, to snag the bronze medal.
Silver medalist representing Canada.
Medalha de prata representando o Canadá.
Tess Routliff.
Well, she burst onto the scene at the 2015 Parapan Games. Four goals, including a silver in the 200 IM, Tess Routliff. She then went on and claimed silver at the 2015 World Championships. Such a strong breaststroke leg. Put her into medal contention and closed strong. Three finals, no medals leading up to this, but she now has a medal around her neck. The 17-year-old New Zealand-born Canadian. Oh, she's delighted. Her first Paralympic Games medal, a silver in a very tough race against stern opposition.
Representing New Zealand.
Medalha de ouro e campeã paralímpica. Representando a Nova Zelândia.
Nikita Haworth.
Well, here she is, and what a bright future she has, the 17-year-old Nikita Haworth. 4 years ago in London, she became New Zealand's youngest ever Paralympian, and now the career that's transpired is one that shows success already, but also a lot of promise for the future. She already has a bronze as well, but this gold will be a very, very sweet victory on top of the World Championships that she won in 2015 in the individual medley. Coached by Steve Hay at club level and John Shaw at national level, and her sister Astrid has also played football for the Cambridge Women's A team in New Zealand, a sporty family indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of New Zealand.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Nova Zelândia.
Senhoras e senhores, as medalhistas paralímpicas.
So the medalists of the women's 200 metres individual medley SM7 classification: Nikita Howarth, Tess Routliffe, and Courtney Jordan. A moment to savour. Howarth and Routliffe, just 17 years of age. Courtney Jordan from the United States, 25. Fantastic support from the crowd here.
This is the final of the men's 100 meter backstroke, S8. Ungles, Carlomagno, Hind, Griswold, Bushinski, Irnenko, Joe, and Mortensen go lanes 1 to 8. Swimmers waiting in the call room. They'll be called onto pool deck one by one. The individual starters in the men's 100 backstroke S8. Swimming in lane 8, representing Denmark, the 21-year-old from Aarhus. No medals at either the Paralympic Games or the World Championships. Wanting to change that. From the 8th lane, Jesse Ungles, representing Australia, the man who made his international debut for Australia at the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow 2 years ago, winning silver in the 200 back, swims the 100 back from lane 1. Cho Kong, the 27-year-old from Jiangsu Province, capital of Jiangsu Province, Nanjing, one of the great cities in China, seriously injured in a car accident at 15, while already a promising swimmer. Pippo Carlomagna goes in lane 2. His father, Fernando, also a Paralympic swimmer, three editions he represented Argentina in, and his mother Mirna was a coach of the Argentine para swimming team. Bohdan Hirnenko, the 21-year-old, goes in lane six for Ukraine. He's yet to win an individual medal at either a World Championships or a Paralympic Games, but he's won a handful of relay medals. Well, Carlo Magna might come from sporting stock, but so too Oliver Hyde, his brother, was a Paralympic champion in Beijing. First off, and now Oliver Hyde is a Paralympic champion, having already won the 400 free. 21-year-old goes in three. Yuri Bushinsky of Ukraine goes in lane five. 24-year-old silver medalist at the 2015 World Championships and indeed the reigning European champion. But Robert Griswold of the United States goes in lane four, the 19-year-old world record holder in the 200 back. The man who set the Paralympic record in heats. His aim is the world record in the final. Robert Griswold, confirmation of his Paralympic record, 105.33, quickest to qualify in the preliminaries. So Griswold, arguably the favorites, goes in lane four. This is a backstroke, so the swimmers will start in the pool. On the competitive track since the age of nine, Robert Griswold a chance to prove his ability in the water here. One of his favorite strokes, the 100 back, world record at 103.32. Ungles, Carlomagno, Hind, Griswold, Bushinsky, Hirnenko, Show, and Mortensen. Hind got off to a decent start, but going in lane two, Carlomagno set the pace off the blocks, but going in lane eight, Niels Mortensen has absolutely gone out flying. Will he be able to maintain this kind of pace? Joe, though, breaks up on his outside and looks to be leading along with Bushinsky and Griswold of Ukraine and the United States, respectively. Hind is not out of this, and indeed, Carlo Magna is not dropping back.
Well, it's difficult to actually pick who's going to touch in at the wall. I think it might be Joe first, but there's not going to be very much in it at all, and a lot depends. It was Joe, 30.54, but a lot depends on that turn as to how they set themselves up and power home for the final 50.
Well, the top five touching just outside a second, and we might not be on world record pace here, but Joe is making a fine race from lane seven. Griswold is fighting to get back into this race. Hind is trying to stay with him. They at the moment are in silver and bronze medal positions, but the battle for silver looks to be Hind coming in, and he's quickened his pace. A world record on the cards here for Show, swimming from lane seven, touches for gold. Hind takes the silver, and Griswold only managing to find the bronze medal in this race. But how about that for challenging? Show Kong went out with one objective in mind, and that was to win the gold medal. He's done it in world record time. Konstantin Lysenkov's world record from the World Championships 3 years ago is gone. Griswold and Hind alongside one another. There's Griswold on the right and Hind on the left. The two congratulating one another. But a phenomenal swim from Joe. Carlo Magna led out early, but aside from that, Joe was virtually leading all the way.
Well, he really made a move in the second 25 of that first length of the pool and had a fantastic turn, came off the wall so strongly and set himself up beautifully. And the other thing that was impressive about his performance was the last 15, he actually put a spurt on, so he still had a little in the tank.
Well, he was behind world record pace until at the 25, and even at the 15 to go, he was only just on world record pace, but suddenly turned it on. Definitely gas in that tank. Came in hot. World record time for Shou Kong. 102.90 for the Chinese swimmer Zhou, ahead of Oliver Hyde, the champion of the 400 free, and Robert Griswold, world record holder in the 200 back, gets bronze in the 100 back at these Paralympic Games in an America's record 104.68. This is the final of the women's 100 backstroke S8, the start list that sees Kaiser, Patterson, Marks, Millwood, Long, Slater, Elliott, and Liu. This is one of those rare races where any one of the eight could win a medal. Liu, where you are, 25-year-old from China, fourth in the 100 fly, goes in lane eight. Cleo Kaiser of the Netherlands, the 18-year-old, posted a 121.81 in the preliminaries. She goes in lane one. Representing Australia, sixth in 2012, Madison Elliott, already gold in the 100 free, now looks to add to her tally with gold in the 100 back. She swims in seven. Lakeisha Patterson goes in lane two for Australia. She too has tasted gold at Rio 2016, gold in the 400 free, silver in the 100 free. Stephanie Slater, a 25-year-old, also a very promising gymnastics athlete when she was younger, decided to pick swimming and was in line to represent Great Britain at the Olympic Games of 2012. Elizabeth Marks, the 26-year-old, gold in the 100 breast in her Paralympic debut. The former combat medic goes in lane three. Also representing the United States of America, going in lane five, silver medalist of 2012, Jessica Long. 20-time Paralympic medalist, the most decorated of all active US Paralympians. We're representing Great Britain. Stephanie Millwood, 34-year-old, has hit her peak at the right time. Bronze in the 100 and 400 free. She took silver in the 100 back S9 in London. She has a career record of seven silvers and three bronzes at the Paralympic Games, no gold, but now is the world record holder and Paralympic record holder from the heats. Stephanie Millwood would fancy changing that statistic as a seven-time medalist with no golds. Her family, anxious, nervous, perhaps can't even watch. Jessica Long sees the funny side of it. Long goes in five alongside Millwood in four. Marks on her outside in three. The Australians, Patterson and Elliott, go in two and seven. And Slater, cannot be discounted, goes in six. Liu Weiyun, Yuan could still swim. Medal time from eight, and Kaiser goes in one for the Netherlands. So Kaiser, Patterson, Marks, Millwood, Long, Slater, Elliott and Liu. Any one of these eight swimmers could claim a medal. It's a rare event that sees that sort of tightness contested between all eight swimmers, but indeed we have it here. The women's 100 back S8 gets underway with a very strong start for Stephanie Slater. Jessica Long always struggles off the start as a double leg amputee, but Millwood gets into a stroke and looks to be the quickest in the pool while swimming in lane eight. Liu Weiyuan, the 25-year-old, missed out in the 100 fly for a medalist. He touched fourth, doesn't want that to happen here. Elliott makes a charge going from lane seven, but at the moment Millwood looks pretty settled as she goes towards the opening 50. Should touch well and truly first.
She will touch well and truly first, looking very comfortable, swimming very close to the lane rope on the far side of the pool. She has a good turn, she's powered off, and she's capitalizing on that now and is opening up quite a lead. I suspect by the 25 meter mark to go. She might even build on that lead further. She's looking very comfortable.
And she's looking on world record pace here. This is a very fast time from Steph Millwood. Just what sort of time is she going to swim here? There's the world record line that comes into shot now. The battle for silver sees Elliott push up into silver, and indeed Patterson is challenging as well as Long fades and Slater starts to fade, but going strong. And perhaps in world record time here, it is Stephanie Millwood, 34-year-old, claims her first ever Paralympic gold medal in the pool as she touches in Paralympic record time. The silver to Elliott, and the bronze goes to Long, out touches Patterson at the wall. Jessica Long collects her 21st career Paralympic medal, but still has yet to taste gold in the pool at Rio 2016. Well, drove her nails into the touchpad at the far end, and she's been shaking her hand since she touched the wall. Perhaps a little awkward from Stephanie Millwood as she went into the wall. But just outside world record time, caught her awkwardly between strokes. Madison Elliott with a silver, a fine silver to go with her gold in the 100 free. And then bronze for the ever smiling, always pleasant silver medalist from 4 years ago. Not her strongest event, Jessica Long.
Jessica Long almost came from nowhere to claim that silver. The jewel was on for the silver, and she must have had a fantastic final 25. We'll have to look at the replay, but there you see Millwood was so strong into the wall, and it was a turn time to perfection and a beautiful performance. And if we just look there, she did actually hit her wrist on the wall as she came in, which is extremely painful and can actually break a bone if you're not careful. So she won't be feeling that too much yet, perhaps a bit of soreness later. She's done extremely well.
Well, a first ever Paralympic Games gold medal for Steph Millwood, and that'll be just an enormous relief as much as the joy that she'll experience. Millwood ahead of Elliott, ahead of Long. Patterson touched out by 0.15 of a second. Slater finishes fifth overall. As Lou faded in the closing stages, so too Marks of USA. Stephanie Millwood at 34. Swam in the S9 classification at London 4 years ago, managed to take silver in the 100 back.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 100 meters freestyle S10.
It's the victory ceremony for the 100 meter freestyle S10 for men. One of those races where the gold could have gone any one of five ways, with Brazil, Rodriguez, Kripak, Dubrov and Crothers all going head to head. In the end, it would be Dubrov and Crothers who would miss out. Rita van der Riel, the governing board member of the International Paralympic Committee, will present the medals.
Be accompanied by the Minister of Sport of the Netherlands.
The Minister of Sport in the Netherlands, Edith Schippers.
This is Edith Schippers. Bronze medalist representing Brazil.
Medalha de bronze representando o Brasil, Felipe Rodrigues.
The 26-year-old silver in the 50 free, but a man who's won silvers in this race behind his compatriot André Brazil at the last two editions of the Paralympic Games. Felipe Rodrigues finally beat Brazil in the 50, but could not beat André Brazil in the 100. He finishes in bronze medal position, having out-touched a man who'd taken five medals already at these games and who was favored to claim the gold, Denis Dubrov.
silver medalist representing Brazil.
Medalha de prata representando o Brasil. André Brasil Esteves.
André Brasil, 32 years of age, he's managed to keep his world record and Paralympic record, but not his gold medal from both London and Beijing. He has to settle for silver this time, does André Brasil, but he also has a bronze in the 100 metres butterfly in Rio and is thoroughly enjoying performing in his home crowd. And it's not the last we'll see of him. There's a very full schedule here and a number of events still to come in the remaining days of the competition.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Ukraine.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico representando a Ucrânia.
Maxim Kripa.
Representing the Ukraine, 21-year-old Maxim Kripak has secured the 50 and 100 free double, having earlier won gold in the 50 free and gold in the 100 back, the silver medalist from the 100 fly and the 200 IM as his fifth medal of Rio 2016. And a relief for the Ukrainian. He's a champion for the third time in Rio 2016. Two Brazilians on the podium, but we'll hear the Ukrainian national anthem.
Senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas paralímpicos.
Well, warm embraces all around. Emotional moment for the two Brazilians. Brazil, two-time defending champion, takes the silver. Rodriguez, his compatriot, takes bronze. Kripak, though, a third gold of Rio 2016. Brazilian fans gathering, cell phones, cameras out, trying to take pictures, capturing images for posterity. One day they'll show their children they were there.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games, Women's 100 Meters Freestyle S10.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos 100 metros nado livre feminino S10 dos Jogos Paralímpicos Rio 2016.
This is the victory ceremony for the Women's 100 Freestyle S10.
Please welcome the medalists.
Por gentileza, dê as boas-vindas às medalhistas.
Pasco and Rivard always talking. The great rivalries in the sport that's built up in recent years. Rivard was too young 4 years ago to genuinely contend and finished fourth outside the medals
Minister of Sport of the Netherlands
in 2012.
So
Edith Schippers will now present the medals, the Minister of Sport in the Netherlands. And Rita van Driel, the governing board member of the International Paralympic Committee, will present the little mascots.
Bronze medalist representing France.
Medalha de bronze representando a França.
Elodie Lorandi,
born in Cannes, the 27-year-old. Swimming to her first medal of Rio 2016. A 400 meter freestyle champion 4 years ago. She finished silver in this event in London. Unable to go one better. Instead, takes the bronze. Lorandi of France.
Silver medalist representing New Zealand.
Medalha de prata representando a Nova Zelândia.
Sophie Pasco.
The silver medalist Sophie Pasco, who has won 5 medals in Rio here in 2016. In 2008, she was the youngest New Zealander to win a Paralympic medal when she won silver in the S10 100 meters butterfly. And hasn't her career propelled on? So now she has 3 gold medals to her name and 2 silver medals to round out a very successful program at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Canada.
Medalha de ouro, campeã paralímpica, representando o Canadá,
Aurelie Rivard.
In 2012, she was just too young and too inexperienced to quite challenge for the medals in this shorter sprint, the Women's 100 Freestyle. But over the last 2 years, she's really come into her own. Canadian Para Swimmer of the Year for the last 2 years. And trains with her twin sister, Charlotte. Pushed in the pool every day virtually. After gold in the 50 free, she's now completed the double 50 and 100 free. After being beaten by Pasco in the 200 IM, Canada has another swimming champion, and it's Rivard's second gold medal of Rio 2016.
Thank you. gentlemen, your Paralympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, as medalhistas.
First to congratulate her on the dais is, of course, Sophie Pascoe. Still a wonderful achievement from the New Zealander, who takes the silver, 5 medals in 5 days, 2 silvers and 3 gold. How's that for recovery time? Lohandi, silver medalist 4 years ago, takes bronze, but Rivard is the champion in the 100 free, as well as the 50 free. Messages from Aurelie's family, including her twin Charlotte in the stands, watching as she set the Paralympic record and took the gold. This now is the men's 50 meter freestyle final S9. The 8 swimmers that'll battle for the gold, silver and bronze medals. Crouch, Toth, Murray, Wiley, Diskin, Yamada, Source and Silver. Going in lane 8, representing Brazil, Raita Silva, 5th in the 100 free final. Goes in lane 8. Ryan Crouch, representing Great Britain, goes in lane 1 and has been swimming since the age of 5. Representing Hungary, going in lane 7, Tamás Sors, silver in the 200 IM. Hungarian Tamás Toth, silver medalist 4 years ago. Bronze in the 100 free already. Representing Japan, Takuru Yamada goes in lane 6 at his 3rd Paralympic Games. Silver medalist at the World Championships. And he got bronze as far back as the 2006 World Championships. Jose Antonio Mari Alcaraz of Spain missed the medals in the 100 and the 400 free finals, hoping for further success, or some success, in this 50 free shootout. Timothy Diskin of Australia, the 19-year-old gold medalist in the 100 free, goes in lane 5, but the man to beat is Matt Wiley of Great Britain, the 19-year-old. Man who trains alongside already Paralympic gold medalist in years gone by. Joseph Craig, got Matthew Kydry. 23 Paralympic medals in the great Matthew Cowdery's decorated career. Still holds the world record and the Paralympic record after his victory 4 years ago in London. Tamás Toth, who goes in lane 2, touched behind Cowdery in London and goes in lane 2. Wiley carrying the great British flag through. While Diskin waving the Australian flag high and looking to continue from where Cowdery left off for Australia. Well, virtually all off in a line, but it's a sprint now. Not too much in terms of reaction time difference between the swimmers. Probably Maria Alcaraz quickest off the block. Diskin, though, looked good in the pool, but just outside him is Yamada, while Sors is looking very strong. Tomas Toth is just losing a little into lane two, but they're virtually all in the line from lanes 1 to 7 here for the gold medal. Can't separate them. It's not going to be world record time, but who's going to touch? I think it's Wiley. It is Wiley ahead of Diskin. Yamada takes the bronze. It's 4, 5, and 6 for 1, 2, 3. Wiley, the 19-year-old out of Sunderland, swims under 26 seconds. The top three, 26 seconds or under, separated by 5 one-hundredths of a second. Wiley beats Diskin, who touches 1 one-hundredth of a second ahead of Yamada for the bronze, and Soares misses out on a medal by 4 one-hundredths of a second. The top six hit the wall in basically 0.2 of a second of one another. That's how tight this race was. They were all off the blocks pretty quickly, but Diskin, arguably the quickest, in the end, managing to medal. But what a race.
Well, Soares will be very disappointed because he actually looked like he had his fingertips in front for the bulk of that 50 metres, and in the end was just touched out. It just comes down to the slimmest of margins, and look at that, a touch in it at the finish line. Incredible stuff.
How about that? Wiley congratulated by Mari Alcaraz, who was swimming in lane three. Spanish swimmer touching fifth fastest. But only 0.16 of a second behind Wiley, the champion. Look at the times, how close they were. The top four separated by 9 one-hundredths of a second. Wiley ahead of Diskin, and the bronze medal, Yamada, takes it only 1 one-hundredth of a second slower than Diskin in silver medal position. That was sensational. This is the final of the women's 50 meter freestyle S9. McConnell, Gascon, Lynn, Conkoli, Cole, Wang, Beecroft, and Marcus Soto. Going in lane 8, Nuria Marcus Soto, the 17-year-old gold medalist in the 400 free. Going in lane 1 for Australia, Ashley McConnell, the 20-year-old. Lemony Beecroft started the year swimming at the Victorian Open Championships, where she took a gold in the 50 fly. We'll feel that she's got the ability as a sprinter. Sarai Gascon goes in lane 2. Silver in both the 100 free and the 200 IM. She's a quality sprinter. Wang Chiyoshin, the 24-year-old who won the 50 and 100 free titles at the 2014 Asian Para Games, goes in 6. Wang's compatriot Lin Ping, the gold medalist in the 200 IM, 22 years old, represents China, goes in lane 3. Ellie Cole, the 24-year-old, silver in the 400 free, bronze in the 100 free, wants to repeat the successes she had in London 2012 and claim gold here, but she's going to have to beat Michelle Conkoli, the 24-year-old, gold in the 100 free. And the frightening thing is that Conkoli has got an explosive start. The good news, though, for those around her is that Conkoli has a very good start, but is very strong in the back end of the 100. If she can close out this opening 50, though, and she's proved she can, setting a new world record earlier this year in Charlotte, North Carolina. Conkoli's got this in the bag if she can swim that type of race, but one of her strengths is undoubtedly the back end of a race. and no chance in a 50 to have that push. McConnell, Gascon, Lin, Conkerley, Cole, Wang, Beecroft, and Mark Soto. Off to a very quick start, going in lane 7 was Emily Beecroft, but as they break the water, it is in lane 4, Conkerley, who is looking strongest and already starting to pull away from Ellie Cole of Australia. Going in lane 2, Sarai Gascon is looking to turn on the pace, while Beecroft has just dropped off ever so slightly, but remains in bronze medal contention. Just about world record pace here. Michelle Conkerley of the United States is going to claim another gold medal, but is it going to be in world record time? It is in Paralympic record time, ahead of Cole. Wang of China takes the bronze. And again, hotly contested. Gascon misses out. She only touches fifth overall. Beecroft misses out on the bronze, but touches fourth overall. But in Paralympic record time at 28:29, Conkerley led the way. Cole first to congratulate her. As Cole takes silver, Wang just behind in bronze. And Beecroft missing a medal by 3/100ths of a second. Conkerley with the gold. Wang with the bronze. Cole with that silver.
Well, you could see there, that crucial start, it counts for everything in the 50, and Conkerley, we know she has got a sharp reaction time, got away so well. Ashley McConnell in lane 1 also had a decent start, as did Emily Beecroft, who faded throughout the second 25, but it was Conkerley all the way in the last 15 and easily touched in Paralympic record time.
Well, a beaming smile. 4 years ago, was not selected for the US para swimming team to go to London. And within 4 years, she's gone from not being selected to being a double Paralympic Games champion. She's just won the 50 free to go with her 100 free gold. Conkerley in Paralympic record time ahead of Ellie Cole of Australia and Wang Qiuxin of China. Oh yes, daughter of Les and Jane Conkerley is most recent victor, Michelle Conkerley.
We move to the men's 100 meters breaststroke SB11 victory
Ladies
ceremony.
The victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 100 meters breaststroke SB11.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos 100 metros lado de peito masculino SB11 dos Jogos Paralímpicos Rio 2016.
And in this event, it was another gold to China, this time to the world record and Paralympic record holder Yang Bozun, who swam brilliantly from lane 3.
Please welcome the medalists.
Silver to the USA and bronze to Japan. You can see him there, the champion, Yang Bozun, 30 years of age. It's unclear how he'd go. He's taken a little bit of time away from the sport to focus on his career, but he's
the medals will be presented
come back
by
with absolute gusto.
As medalhas serão entregues pelo membro da Ordem Paralímpica,
Mr. Hans Lindstrom.
The medal presenter, Mr. Hans Lindstrom, a Paralympic Order recipient.
He'll be accompanied by Logistic Director of Rio 2016.
And Fernando Cotrim is assisting him. He's the Rio 2016 Director.
Bronze medalist representing Japan.
Medalha de bronze representando o Japão.
Keiichi Kimura.
The 26-year-old Keiichi Kimura now has a bronze medal to add to the silver he won in the 50 metres freestyle S11. Hails from the capital, Tokyo. And of course was also the executive director of Japan's Paralympic Committee, so has a very, very busy life indeed, and will be extremely busy, it would have to be said, over the next 4 years as his home city prepares to host the next Paralympic Games. Multiple medalist in London and competed in Beijing, but he's been a huge improver, particularly in the last 4 years.
Silver medalist representing the United States of America.
Medalha de prata representando os Estados Unidos da América.
Tharron Drake of the United States officially resides in Colorado Springs, the home of the U.S. Olympic Training Center. The son of Sean and Karen Drake, proudly seeing their son take another silver to go with the 400 free silver he won, shaking the medal, the silver, the gold, silver and bronze have little spheres inside them that when shaken sound different. They also have braille on the medals for the visually impaired swimmers, such as this classification, the S11.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion, representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico, representando a República Popular da China.
Yang Bo Sun,
well, he's twice retired from the sport, would you believe? He retired from para swimming to become a teacher after London 2012. Then he decided to quit his job and resume his sporting career in 2015. He'd previously retired after the 2008 Paralympic Games, and he's back in fine fashion, 30 years of age, broke his own world record to take gold in this event. Already has a bronze for the men's 50 metres freestyle, and still the 200 IM and 100 free to come. A special moment for Yang Bo Sun.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the People's Republic of China.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República Popular da China.
Senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas paralímpicos.
The men's 100 meters breaststroke SB11 classification. The medalist there you see on your screen, it's Yang Bo Sun, center stage. The reigning champion bettered his world mark again in the final, and to the left, Drake. And to the right of screen, you can see Keiichi Kimura, the bronze medalist, and Chinese supporters out having a great time here at the pool because, of course, China is enjoying such success at these games. A special moment here for these three athletes, enjoying the moment straight after the victory ceremony. The Kimura supporters trying to beckon him to come over so they can pass on their personal congratulations. And the awaiting media capturing the perfect shot. The women's 100 metres breaststroke SB11 victory ceremony. Games.
Women's 100 metres breaststroke SB11.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos 100 metros nado de peito feminino SB11 nos Jogos Paralímpicos Rio 2016.
Well, again in this event, gold all the way for China.
Please welcome the medalists.
And another world record as well for Zhang Xiaotong. Just 17 years of age. Lisette Brainsma from the Netherlands, the silver medalist in this event, and Maya Rackard from Sweden, the bronze. But it was a decisive win for Zhang Xiaotong. 123.02.
Bronze medalist,
the world
representing
record.
Sweden.
Medalha de bronze representando a Suécia.
Maya Rijkaard.
Maya Rijkaard is the 25 years of age. This is her second bronze medal of these games, and she also has a silver in the women's 50 meters freestyle. She was the defending Paralympic champion. She was Sweden's flag bearer for the opening ceremony. Bronze it is this time as she shakes her medal. She's a student of environmental engineering in Stockholm. And we'll see more of her here. Still another three events to come.
Silver medalist representing the Netherlands.
Medalha de prata representando Países Baixos.
Lisette Brainsma.
Lisette Brainsma, the excitable and flamboyant character from the Netherlands. Just 16 years old. She now has the complete collection of medals at the Paralympic Games of 2016. She won gold in the 400 free and then remarkably dead heated for the bronze in the women's 50 free S11 with Marina Podobna of the Ukraine. But now she has a silver medal to complete her collection in three events. She has three medals and she's finished first, third, and now second in the women's 100 breaststroke SB11. The novelty of the medal with the noise. Shakes it furiously.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de ouro, campeã paralímpica representando a República Popular da China.
Zhang Xiaotong.
Zhang Xiaotong, the Chinese athlete, just 17 years of age. She's burst onto the scene here. This is her only event in Rio. And she's done it in style, setting a world record 123.02. And hails from Liaoning province in northeastern China, the vast nation that's producing so many champions here in Rio.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the People's Republic of China.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República Popular da China.
the medalists for the women's 100 meters breaststroke SB11 and the youngster 17-year-old Zhang Xiaotong. You can see center screen there. Her first Paralympic medal, the only event she's swimming here in Rio. It's the only time we'll see her, and what a way to take the spotlight. Maya Rijkaard to the right of screen from Sweden was the defending Paralympic champion. This time must settle for bronze. And Lisette Breinsma from the Netherlands, the silver medalist on the left of screen. Swedish supporters there, been very vocal at the Olympic Aquatic Stadium. And there they are, Team Maya. Very pleased to be here, and she's celebrating her bronze medal. Perhaps not the colour she would have liked, but enjoying the moment, 25 years of age and already a very successful Paralympic career to date.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games, men's 100 metres breaststroke SB12.
The victory ceremony for the men's 100 metres breaststroke SB12 classification. And we'll see here an athlete from the team that's enjoying so much success here in Rio in 2016. The Ukraine, that is, and Udazimir Izotau, who performed very strongly as expected, setting a Paralympic record time of 106.82. So, bettering the previous record by almost half a second.
Bronze medalist representing Ukraine.
Which is set 4 years ago.
Representando a Ucrânia.
Maxim Varaxa.
So Maxim Varaxa takes the bronze medal, the 32-year-old.
Great job. Thank you very much.
He's taken the bronze medal, a time of 109.00.
Silver medalist representing Azerbaijan.
Medalha de prata representando Azerbaijan.
Dmitry Salih.
Dmitry Salih, the 26-year-old, now representing Azerbaijan. When he won the 100 fly in Beijing 8 years ago, he was representing the country of his birth, Belarus. He switched nations ahead of the 2014 European Championships, and it's his first Paralympic medal representing Azerbaijan. The older of the Salih brothers, his younger brother Rahman, will hope for Paralympic medals, but what an inspiration to look up to. Dmitry Salih is a silver medalist in the 100 breaststroke SB12.
gold medalist and Paralympic champion, representing Belarus.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico, representando Belarus.
Yelyzaveta from Belarus, winning the Paralympic gold medal. He set a Paralympic record in his heat and then broke that record to swim a 106.82 in the final. A stunning performance. We knew this was his head event. He had silver in London and bronze in Beijing, so he's improving game by game. Isatau from Belarus, the new Paralympic champion in the men's 100 metres breaststroke SB12.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Belarus.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino de Belarus.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas paralímpicos.
On the center of your screen there, Uladzimir Isatau from Belarus, the 28-year-old, the new Paralympic champion in Paralympic record time of 106.82. Dmitry Saleh from Azerbaijan, the silver medalist in 108.80, and Maxim Varaksa from Ukraine, 109.00. Swedish supporters there and Ukrainian supporters in the crowd. The waiting media. Final of the men's 50 metres freestyle S3 classification. And there was a world record set in qualifying in the heats in the earlier session on day 6 of the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. Sweden, 3 athletes from China, they're going to swim side by side, Ukraine, Italy, Spain and Greece. But the man to swim from 4, Huang Wenpan, broke the world record this morning. The world record time of 40.51 is the new mark. Ioannis Kostakis, 44 years of age, the bronze medalist in Athens in the 100 free. Mikael Fredriksson will swim from lane 1 from Sweden, 25 years of age. He made the backstroke final. Has 2 more events, including the 50 free and the medley. Miguel Martinez Tejulo, 32 years of age. He was outside the medals in London and Beijing. He'd dearly love a medal here. Li Hanhua will swim in two. He already has a relay gold medal. He's more of a longer distance freestyle swimmer, prefers the 200, a silver in Beijing in that event. One bronze in London in the 150 IM. Vincenzo Boni, third at the World Championships in this event. Bronze here in the 50 metres backstroke. Would love a medal here. And now another Chinese athlete. The three will swim side by side. Du Jianping, 32 years of age, a gold medalist in London and Beijing and Athens. Hails from Zhejiang. The best he's done in the 53 was silver in Athens and Beijing. Dmytro Bronraditz from Ukraine, 31 years of age, gold in the 50 metres backstroke. Huang Wenpan set the world record in the heat, has a relay gold as well. 50 metres backstroke silver and hails from Sichuan province in China. Beautiful part of the world. As we prepare for the final, and there you see on the screen confirmation of Huang's world record and Paralympic record mark is set in the heats for this event. 40.51 seconds. So the 21-year-old from China, the hot favourite in lane four for this event. See him slide into the pool. So the option for an in-pool or block start here. Huang to swim in four. And they're away, almost all swimmers opting to start in the pool, and Huang is off to a flying start. It's fair to say he has the early advantage, just trying to sit out a lead. The Ukrainian is in the next lane. He's staying on his right shoulder, and over in lane two, Han Hua is also having a great swim. But it is Huang who's going to take it through. He's looking so strong. He's backed up extremely well from the quick time he set this morning. He's hovering around world record pace. It doesn't look as though he'll get there, though he has a push to the wall. Look at this. Well, would you mind, two world records in one day set, one in the morning, one in the evening. Huang Wenpan, it'll be silver to Ukraine and bronze to China as well. Only thanks his supporters there. What a great swim. So confirmation there, it was 39.24, more than a second quicker than his heat this morning. And the Ukrainian swimming at 41.41, so a clear winner there. Huang, such a strong swim and an amazing swim really to back up after the quick time he set in the early session on day six.
Well, it was the way he finished, I think, is most impressive. Yes, he started strong and started to pull away from Bronraditz, the Ukrainian swimmer, and a very fine swim from Li Hanhua, who sees him claim the bronze medal. But Bronraditz with a big PB, so it'll stand as a European record now, considering Huang has just gone and broken his own world record by a significant margin. But the way he sped up was incredible. He was just about world record pace at the halfway mark, and by the time he got himself into his flow, great rhythm by the 25 meter mark, and then just continued to speed up, and he charged towards the wall, propelled himself into the wall in world record time. Vinaradets, no answer, but he did have the charging Li Hanhua to keep at bay for the silver medal. What a finish from Huang Wenpan.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how Huang swims the 200 freestyle, because we've seen that he obviously had a fair bit left in the tank at the end of that 50. In fact, almost seemed to just be warming into it. So we'll still see him in the 200 free and the 150 IM. So that'll be a good swim as well to watch for Huang Wenpan. And he's also going to swim in the 50 breaststroke as well. But incredible kick in that last 15 metres or so. So confirmation there of the new world record mark of 39.24 over a second quicker than the previous mark he set in the early session. So, and it will be China bronze as well. China 3-4, Italy 5. Spain 6, Greece, Kostakis in 7th, and Fredriksson from Sweden finished in 8th position in a time of 55.74.
Well, Huang leaves the pool deck as a champion here and will face the media. The smile on the face of Miguel Martinez of Spain was just enormous. And a big PB by nearly a second for the Spaniard just meant so much. He might have finished sixth, but that's the story of the Paralympic Games, the joy it brings.
We move on to the men's 200 metres freestyle S4 classification. And a roll through the start list there sees Jing, Gustavo, Sanchez, Martinez, Schoenmaker, Joe, who is expected to do very well in this event, Juric, Smetanin, Povasil, and Derevinsky. Derevinsky from Ukraine, 28 years of age, already has a relay bronze medal in these games as he comes out to take to the starting blocks. He has a qualifying time of 3:18.59, but we know he's capable of much quicker than that, 3:12. So he could well feature in the medals, even though he's swimming well outside the main prospects in lane 8. Jin Jipeng from China, 24 years of age, already 2 silver medals already. They were in the 100 free and 150 medley. Hails from the Chinese capital, Beijing. Qualifying time of 3:13.42. Jan Povasil will swim from lane 7. He had a bronze in this event in Beijing. This is his 5th Paralympic Games, 34 years of age. 3:13.02 was his qualifying time. Gustavo Sanchez Martinez, he's the reigning Paralympic champion. He swam a 2:58.09 in London. He's yet to medal in Rio. He'd dearly love to retain his title here. But has been swimming outside his best over this distance. We'll see if he can lift for the final. Smetanin, David Smetanin from France. Silver in this event in Beijing and in London. This is his 4th Paralympic Games at the age of 41. 3:05.38. Should feature among the medals if he has a good race here. Michael Schoenmaker from the Netherlands. He's already won a bronze in the 100 metres free. Was 7th in this event in London, won the breaststroke gold in London, 33 years of age. Darko Juric, 27 years of age from Slovenia. He was outside the medals in London, finishing 4th. He's also a member of the Slovenian sitting volleyball national youth team, so an all-round athlete is focusing on swimming for now. And Jo Ji-song from Korea will go into this event as favourite based on recent form at least. He's by far the quickest qualifier, a second and a half quicker than Schoenmaker and Juric. Already has a gold in the 100 free. He's the 2015 and 2014 world champion. He's been a huge improver and still has the 50 free yet to come. There's the world mark, 2:55.81. So Joe will swim in lane number 4. Juric in 5. And on the other side of Joe, Schoenmaker from the Netherlands will swim in lane 3. But don't forget about the reigning Paralympic champion, Sanchez Martinez, the 22-year-old. He's swimming in lane 2. So the 200 metres freestyle. S4 classification, the option of starting in pool or on pool deck or on the starting blocks. It's a decision left up to athletes and their coaches. Juric on the blocks, Sanchez Martinez also off the blocks, and well, it was a quick start there for Joe, and he's showing his intentions early in lane 4, hoping to open up an early lead. Remember, there's 4 lengths of the pool, and it's a difficult event to swim, particularly with a packed Paralympic program. Joe taking the early lead, although Jin Jepang in lane 1 is also having a great swim, and it's reasonably even between the pair.
Well, at the moment, it's very difficult to pick outside of the leader, Jo Kisung of Korea. But outside of Joe, the next 4 fastest are all in a line virtually. Sanchez Martinez, Schoenmaker, Juric and Smetany. At the turn, though, there are, well, within a second of one another from second to sixth in this race. But it is indeed Joe of Korea who leads. Schoenmaker, the 100 free. Bronze medalist looking good for second overall. Sanchez Martinez touching third fastest. But what is disappointing about Sanchez Martinez is being unable to post anything near his personal best. If he swims a personal best, he's a 2:58 swimmer. But he hasn't gone anywhere near a 3:06 in recent times. In fact, swam a 3:07 to claim the bronze at the World Championships last year. But Juric is the one to watch for a real silver medal. He and Schoenmaker should challenge for that silver medal position, but at the halfway mark in the pool, it's Joe who is working a little magic, leading from the front and trying to chase down the world record of Richard Uribe. I fear he's off the pace, but he might just produce a big back end, the Korean swimmer. 100 and 200 world champion, having won the 100 here, he'll feel confident of winning this 200, and indeed is now a body length ahead. But in lane 3, Schoenmaker and Juric in lane 5 are virtually level with one another.
Well, he's really starting to stretch now. Joe stretching out those lovely long strokes, and he's making it easily into the wall first. It'll be interesting to see the split time. So about 2 seconds slower on that second 50. The first one was a ripper. He swam the first 50 in 40 seconds, 41 seconds almost, 45 for the second. It's dropping slightly, 47, but I wonder whether he's planning this race to know that he has the strength and endurance to come home strongly. At the moment, it looks as though Schoenmaker has clearly made it into second position, but the battle is going to be on for the bronze, because over in lane 1, we have the Chinese athlete Jin Jepang. And then in 5, we've got Juric, and Juric really would dearly love a medal in this event. And unfortunately, Sanchez Martinez, who we've mentioned has been swimming well off his best pace, is fading very much to the back of the field. Well, Joe Jusung has touched in first. It's well above record pace, 3:01. 3:01.67, the confirmation of the time there. 2 seconds ahead of Schoenmaker, and Jepang will touch in for the bronze, but there we have it, much to the delight of the Korean fans here. 3:01.67 is the winning mark, so still about 6 seconds behind the world and Paralympic record mark. Schoenmaker delighted with his second place. Look at that. the glee. And there you have Ginger Peng, the bronze medalist. 3:03.94. So not a lot of difference on the clock between silver and bronze. After that, it's Juric who came in fourth position in 3:05.02. Smetanin fifth in 3:06.39. Well, the turns matter in the 200. Not quite as critical as in the 100 metres, but you can see the different styles. Of course, the freestyle, for some athletes, are permitted a different kicking pattern depending on impairment. And an easy touch in at the wall there, and he's enjoying that, isn't he? Joji Song, he was the hot favourite going in, and look at him, draped in the flag. A big thumbs up, and Team Korea thrilled for their athlete as he signals to the adoring crowd. What an achievement.
The Korean fans appropriately delighted.
Indeed, so confirmation there, Joji Song. The gold medalist in a time of 3:01.67, Schoenmaker 3:03.81. Ginger Peng, who was swimming in lane one, had water all to himself out there, 3:03.94. Then it's Juric, Smetanin, Sanchez, Martinez, Povasil, and Derevinsky rounding out the top eight.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 100 metres backstroke.
This is the victory ceremony for the men's 100 metre backstroke S8.
Senhoras e senhores, premiação dos Jogos Paralímpicos de 2016, prova dos 100 metros nado de costas masculino S8.
The medalists, Joe, Hind, and Grizzle.
The medals will be presented by governing board member of the International Paralympic Committee,
Mr. Yasushi Yamawaki, governing board member of the International Paralympic Committee, will present the medals.
Accompanied
by the technology director of Rio 2016, Mr. Eli Rezende.
Bronze medalist representing the United States of America.
Medalha de bronze representando os Estados Unidos da América.
Robert Griswold.
Very excited to be on the podium. The 19-year-old set a Paralympic record in the heats. World record was his aim in the final. But Robert Griswold had to swim in America's record to claim the bronze medal. His first ever Paralympic Games medal. It's a bronze in the men's 100 backstroke S8.
Silver medalist representing Great Britain.
Medalha de prata representando a Grã-Bretanha,
Oliver Hind.
The 21-year-old from Great Britain, Oliver Hind. He won a bronze in this event in London 4 years ago, so he's gone one better this time with a silver, and it adds to his gold medal for the 400 metres freestyle. Had a disrupted lead up to the Games in London 4 years ago, but this time round clearly is in excellent form and still has the 200 IM to go and also the freestyle and freestyle relay.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico, representando a República Popular da China.
Zhou Kong.
Zhou Kong of the People's Republic of China. The swimming one event at Rio 2016. His first Paralympic Games. And how to make it count. Not only did he set a world record 102.90 to win the gold, he in fact set a new world record at the 50 meter mark as well. A 30.54 at the turn means he set two world records in one race and claimed the gold medal in his only Paralympic event. It's a decent return for Zhou Kong, gold medalist in the men's 100 backstroke S8.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of
now
the
for the national
Republic
anthem of China.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República Popular da China.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas paralímpicos.
The Paralympic medalists in the men's 100 meter backstroke S8. Robert Griswold of the United States takes bronze in a big PB and America's record 104.68. Oliver Hine, 104.46 for silver. And Zhou Kong, world record 102.9, takes gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016
Paralympic the victory Games. Ceremony for the women's 100-meter backstroke S8.
Senhoras e senhores, cerimônia de premiação dos Jogos Paralímpicos Rio 2016, prova dos 100 metros nado de costas feminina S8.
Please welcome the medalists.
Gentileza, dê as boas-vindas às medalhistas.
Bronze medalist representing the United States of America.
Medalha de bronze representando os Estados Unidos da América.
Jessica Long.
Representing the United States of America, the silver medalist of 4 years ago, Jessica Long takes bronze. She now has an incredible 21 Paralympic medals. She's a 12-time champion. Only five swimmers, female swimmers, have more gold medals, and only two have more medals. Teresa Perales, who's still competing, and arguably the greatest of them all, Trisha Zorn. That is some achievement, despite not claiming a bronze yet at Rio 2016 for Jessica Long.
Silver medalist representing Australia.
Medalha de prata representando Australia.
Madison Elliott.
17 years of age, Madison Elliott. She was bronze in this event in London. She's gone one better here in Rio to take the silver medal. And that is an addition to the gold medal she won in the women's 100 metres freestyle S8. With still another four events to come, including the women's 200 metres individual medley. And swims in Newcastle in the Australian state of New South Wales. And was the 2015 Paralympic Swimmer of the Year.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Great Britain.
Medalha de ouro, campeã paralímpica, representando a Grã-Bretanha.
Stephanie Millwood.
Well, Stephanie Millwood swam for Team GB before being diagnosed as a 17-year-old with multiple sclerosis. Turned to para swimming and excelled in London. She took five podium finishes in London, one bronze, four silvers, and already having claimed bronze in the 100 and 400 free coming into this event, might have been wondering when the gold was going to come. But Stephanie Millwood, for the first time in her decorated Paralympic Games career, is a gold medalist and Paralympic champion. It's come in the 100 backstroke S8.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Great Britain.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Grã-Bretanha.
Enjoy the moment, relish the moment, savor the moment. Stephanie Millwood and a Paralympic record 1:13.02 ahead of Madison Elliott, who set an Oceania record in claiming silver. And Jessica Long, now the third most decorated Paralympian in the pool of all time, a 1:18.12 claims the bronze for her 21st Paralympic Games medal. Jessica Long knows what it's like to be on top of that podium. And now Stephanie Millwood, who only started swimming because she grew up where she was born in Saudi Arabia, where her parents were working at the time, rather warm in the Middle East, certainly in Saudi Arabia, took to the pool to try to cool down regularly. It became something she showed promise in, and indeed has been a swimmer her entire life virtually. But for the first time in her life, she's now a Paralympic champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 50 meters freestyle S9.
This is the victory ceremony for the men's 50 meter freestyle S9. Os 50 metros
já do livre masculino S9 dos Jogos Paralímpicos Rio 2016.
Please welcome the medalists.
Gentileza, dê as boas-vindas aos medalhistas.
Bronze medalist representing Japan.
Medalha de bronze representando o Japão.
Takura Yamada.
Takura Yamada, 25-year-old, silver at the 2015 World Championships. A man who was claiming titles as far back as the 2006 World Championships. At his third Paralympic Games, claims a bronze medal in the men's 50-meter freestyle S9. Delighted with his efforts.
Silver medalist representing Australia.
Medalha de prata representando a Austrália.
Timothy Diskin.
The 19-year-old who was born in Melbourne and already has a gold and a bronze here in Rio. That gold for the 100 free, so now he has the box set with a silver medal as well. Comes from a sporting family. His older brother Jeff has played water polo at state level in Australia. And he still will swim in the freestyle and medley relay events later in the Rio program. The silver medalist, the 50 metres freestyle S9.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Great Britain.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico representando a Grã-Bretanha.
Matthew Wiley.
Man who trains in the city of Sunderland. Great emerging talent is Matt Wiley. He's certainly come on in recent years. 2014, when he made his first international appearance swimming at the European Championships in Eindhoven, he qualified for the 400 freestyle final and indeed the 50 freestyle final. He finished eighth in the 50 on that occasion. 2 years later, he's standing at the top of the podium at the Paralympic Games, just as he did earlier this year in the 50 freestyle S9 at the European Championships. Matt Wiley. Fantastic performance from Wiley to win the gold, 25.95. Matt Wiley not only being acknowledged but being applauded by those that remain in the venue, the Olympic Aquatic Stadium. Very proud supporters. Matt Wiley takes gold, 4/100ths of a second ahead of Tim Diskin, who takes the silver. who took the silver just 1/100th of a second ahead of Yamada. 5/100ths of a second separated those three. But it's Wiley on top of the podium, on top of the world right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games Women's 50-meter freestyle S9.
This is the victory ceremony for the Women's 50-meter freestyle S9.
Paralímpicos Rio 2016, prova dos 50 metros do livre feminino S9.
Medals to be presented by International Paralympic Committee governing board member, Mr. Miguel Sagara.
Accompanied by the Army Physical Training Center.
Man from the Army Physical Training Center, Lieutenant Colonel Luciano Vieira.
Bronze medalist representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de bronze representando a República Popular da China.
Wang Jixin.
Bronze medalist, 24-year-old Wang Jixin of People's Republic of China. Well, when she won the 50 and 100 free titles at the 2014 Asian Para Games, there was an expectation that she would challenge for a medal in the events, and indeed in the women's 53 S9, she's not only challenged, she has successfully completed her task and she's won a medal. It's a bronze in the 53 S9 for Wang Jixin.
Silver medalist representing Australia.
Medalha de prata representando Australia.
Ellie Cole.
24 years of age, Ellie Cole. It's her second silver medal. She was silver in the 400 free and had a bronze also in the 100 free. She was bronze in London in this event, so she's improved her standing and has overcome so much to be here, including surgery on both shoulders in 2013, and she considered quitting the sport but decided after some time out she loved competing. Now she's back on the international stage with a vengeance.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing the United States of America.
Medalha de ouro e campeã paralímpica representando os Estados Unidos da América.
Michelle Conkoli.
Michelle Conkoli of the United States, the 24-year-old who won the 100 free, is now on the 50 free. It's not a dream anymore for Conkoli. She said what's got her out of bed every morning for the last year and a half was the dream of winning gold in her first Paralympic final. She did that with 100, and she's gone just as good in the 50 free S9, her second Paralympic Games final. And she's now a double Paralympic Games champion.
The United States of America.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino dos Estados Unidos da América.
The champion from the United States of America. She's deferred attending medical school to train for the Paralympic Games, and now she's a double champion of the 50 and 100 free. Wang Chuxin takes bronze, Ellie Cole takes silver, and Michelle Conkoli of the United States takes the gold in the women's 50 free S9. Daughter of Les and Jane. Ellie Cole too has family and friends in the stands.
The Rio 2016 Paralympic Games.
The victory ceremony for the men's 50 metres freestyle S3 classification.
Cerimônia de premiação dos 50 metros nado livre masculino S3 dos Jogos Paralímpicos Rio 2016.
And again, it was gold to China, silver to Ukraine, and bronze to China. Huang Wenpan swinging, swimming in world record time of 39.24, taking more than a second off the previous mark that he'd set when he swam the heats in the first session of the day.
medalist representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de bronze representando a República Popular da China.
Li Hanhua.
34 years of age, this bronze medal adds to the relay gold that he's already won here in Rio. Hails from Guangdong province and was involved in a biking accident in 1999, which resulted in a spinal cord injury and paraplegia. He's a strong swimmer over the 200 metres freestyle and also a medalist in Beijing and London. So this bronze adding to his collection.
Silver medalist representing Ukraine.
Medalha de prata representando a Ucrânia.
Dmytro Vinohradets.
Dmytro Vinohradets will feel mildly disappointed. Not about missing out on any times, but indeed missing out on a gold. He swam a personal best, a European record, 41.41. But he's won the world championship title at the last four world championships. He won gold in the 50 back. He won this title as far back as 2008. But is a silver medalist in the men's 50
gold
freestyle S3.
Paralympic champion representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico, representando a República Popular da China.
Yuan Wenpan.
So the new world record holder, the new Paralympic gold medalist, Huang Wenpan. So set a world record in his heat, then bettered that time. Already has a 50 metres backstroke silver medal, a gold medal from the relay, 21 years of age, from Sichuan province in China. Was born with cerebral palsy and now has that world record to his name of 39.24.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the People's Republic of China.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República Popular da China.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Paralympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas paralímpicos.
The medalists in the men's 50 metres freestyle S3 classification. The centre of screen is Huang Wenpan, the 21-year-old from China, 39.24, the world record. Bion Radit, the silver medalist, 31 years of age. 41.41 was his time, and Li Hanhua from China, the bronze medalist in 42.18.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games men's 200 metres freestyle S4.
This is the men's 200 metres freestyle S4 classification victory ceremony. The athletes being brought out. They are. The first you can see on your screen who was waving to the crowd is Ginger Peng from China. We have Michael Schoenmaker from the Netherlands. And the gold medalist who you can see on your screen now is Jo Ji Song from Korea. We set a time of 3 minutes, 1.67 seconds to take the gold medal. Was never really in doubt. Gold such a strong performance.
Representing the People's Republic of China.
Medalha de bronze, representando a República Popular da China.
Jin Jipeng.
Jin Jipeng, 24 years of age and already has 2 silver medals, so the bronze to add to his collection. The silvers in the 100 free and 150 medley. Resides in Beijing. And we'll see him also in the men's 50 metres breaststroke SB3 classification.
Silver medalist representing the Netherlands.
Medalha de prata representando Países Baixos.
Michael Schoenmaker, a silver medalist to add to the bronze he's already won in the men's 100 freestyle S4. So he's made the podium on both his freestyle races. A 303.81, a fine time for Michael Schoenmaker. Young man from Breda in the Netherlands.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing the Republic of Korea.
Medalha de ouro, campeão paralímpico, representando a República da Coreia.
Jo Ji Seong.
Well, he's twice been the world champion and now he is the Paralympic champion. 20-year-old Jo Ji Seong already has a gold in the 100 metres free. He's been a huge improver over the past few years and this really is the icing on the cake of a lot of hard work. In 2015, he was the best para athlete. Awarded the best para athlete at the National Para Games in the Republic of Korea.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the Republic of Korea.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República da Coreia.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Paralympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas paralímpicos.
Colourful characters indeed. They remain for the very last of the victory ceremonies for one of the Korean heroes. And Joe was kept so long by the Korean media, he had to eventually have one of his support staff come and grab him and take him off to get changed into his tracksuit ahead of the medal presentation. But he's now got another medal around his neck. He's a 100 and 200 champion, not only at the World Championships, but at the Paralympic Games as well, and he's only 20 years old. Seoul-born, but lives in Busan. Team Schoenmaker delighted as well. After a bronze in the 100, he's got silver in the 200. Steadily improving is the youngster. And Jin Jipeng of People's Republic of Korea, of People's Republic of China. 303.94 took the bronze. It was a day that saw five world records fall in the finals as 15 gold medal events were swum and contested. China again finishing top of the medal standings on the day with four golds in the pool, Ukraine three and Great Britain two. The very last champion on the evening session, the final session on day six, Joe of Korea. Well, that concludes the final session on day six of the swimming competition of the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. We look forward to your company for the heats program on day seven of competition. But until then, from the Olympic Aquatic Stadium, it's goodbye.